D&D on.
I'm always so fucking ready.
Wait.
I've been playing Pokemon for 10 hours again.
Wait, your
fault, not mine. Please tell me you took snack breaks at least.
No, of course not.
No, my God.
Hush, everyone. Be patient.
I'm recording because I'm already recording. So all this Pokemon is a snack.
This is all on.
Okay.
Fuck.
Recording.
Hi.
Recording. There.
Hi.
Hopefully everything's okay now.
Now that we're
recording, I have to go right directly in.
I would like to apologize in advance if my internet cuts out for a little bit. It's been kind of weird the last week.
Oh dear.
Not like long periods, but it's kind of spotty.
I wish I had an Ethernet cord so I can connect straight into the internet.
I do, and for some reason it's not good enough. I don't know.
Oh no.
Yeah it's. I'm really enjoying this.
I had a terrible incident where my entire computer froze earlier today, so I'm hoping that freak accident doesn't happen again.
Yikes.
Like I wasn't doing anything. I had Steam open and Google Chrome. I was watching some speedrun, and it just froze. No context. I didn't move the cursor. I couldn't move the cursor. I couldn't see it.
Mm-hmm.
Relatable.
Like, it even did that really terrible thing where the audio was stuck on 1 second, and it was just playing that repeatedly.
That's the worst.
Yeah.
That is very bad.
Welcome to hell.
Yeah.
My name's Satan. Here's my soundtrack.
Yeah.
That's cool.
And so, like, I had to, like, hold down the power button and everything and turn it off, and I just now turned it back on, you know, for this. And it seems okay.
Yes. So, McCloud, you give me the good
our god of music
feel.
So we were sleeping, right?
Yeah, and I said that.
Yeah, we just went to bed, which is why I'm changing things.
Gotta look at my spells.
Yeah, who?
Which is why that Kaylin said jolted up and said pigeon's dream of bread. And
then I was gonna mention the bread. It was something about the birds bread. And bread, and then Noah's like, bread.
Yeah, because we could hear it through the walls. Like, it was me and Kaylin, and Kaylin was like, what do pigeons dream about? And Merritt started thinking about it, but he was like, and then Kaylin chimed in with, bread! And Merritt's like, yes! And that was heard through the halls.
Because, like, I imagine, like, Reverence and Margray are, like, to the farthest left room.
Mm-hmm.
Mary and Karen are in the middle, and Nolan and Penn would be in the furthest right. So I imagine, like, when Kaylin jolted up, everybody heard it.
Yeah.
Holy shit, we just got cake delivered to us. Thank you.
Thank you for getting the cake out, Mom.
Do you have enough to share?
Did you have enough to share with the class?
I had cookies I shared with class. I shared my cookies.
I mean, I did make a lot of cake. There was only some, like, the system.
If there isn't cake in my desk by tomorrow, I'm firing all of you. All of you.
You can't fire me.
Are we being paid?
Oh, yeah. Hello?
Fuck. Okay, bye. It's been good. I gotta go now.
Don't come back. I just have a box of fruit roll-ups next to me. I'm just like, it's empty. Why is there fruit roll-up box next to me?
Why are you taunting yourself like that?
It makes me so sad.
Just throw it away. Just throw.
My trash can's full.
Just throw it nearby. It's fine. It's a box. You'll know it's there.
So, like, D&D?
Yeah.
So, play D&D?
Yes.
Yeah.
Desperately.
Yes.
Yeah.
So much.
And hopefully, my twin doesn't interrupt us again. With useless questions.
Straight up say fuck off, I'm playing D&D. They understand this is important to you.
I put myself to do not disturb because I do not want to get anything.
Let's see.
especially to be harassed and be dragged.
Just a place to set this down.
Yeah, I would also like to let them know.
Put family on pause. No more family allowed. It's Dungeons and Dragons time. Music, dead.
There's an issue with that, though.
Online family time.
There's an issue with no family allowed because me and Chan.
No family allowed.
What if you have to leave?
But you guys gotta choose which one goes and which one stays.
Oh shit.
Siren stays.
Oh shit.
No mercy.
Like, I like how quick that was, though.
That's awful.
Like, it didn't take 2 seconds.
Listen, when we're all trapped on an island,
it's all good.
And one of us has to be eaten, we know.
No. That's okay.
I'm not gonna eat him.
You say that now, but give it a
please quick. Murder me quickly. Murder me quickly so you can eat me on this island.
No.
Please just kill me. You guys ready to play?
I just want to be killed instantly.
Awesome.
Yes!
Please!
Yes.
Please.
Going anyway.
I like how every time I ask you something, Brit. Play Dungeons and Dragons.
Please!
Oh, jeez.
Last session, maybe last couple. You're all rich. Just kidding, it's mostly Margaret. Discovered that the sister city of Sunaris to Mesa had crumpled into the lake that it was built in.
Rip.
Ripperoni.
It's dead. You killed
we,
it.
We saved some folks.
You saved?
I had flight spells and rope.
You went in, you spent a while, along with a large amount of people, just helping people and pulling them out of the water and dragging them so people are safe. And after
Kaylin
a long,
a new rock.
Long day of that, Kaylin got a new rock and you went home. No, after a long day of that, you found each other all again, found your money, went to a hotel, rented a couple of rooms, sat down. Talk about bread and pigeons for a while. Margaret talked about something. It's not important, probably.
She,
I don't remember it.
She called me out really hard on writing a letter to Rizwan.
Mm-hmm.
There
she,
it is.
I walked right into what she set me up for.
They were kind.
Such a good
talking
moment.
Being a wolf.
It was so.
So what did you write Rizwan to? You didn't see anything.
Saw it, you would know. In my letter to Rizwan. Fuck.
It was so good. I saw it from a mile off. I was like, there's no way she knows. And then you were like, wait.
Mari got you real hard. And then you all went to sleep. And now it's the next morning. Rise and shine, shit heads. It's time to play Dungeons & Dragons Hell and Woman Traveler.
I really hope that Margaret, out of character, just came in, burst out, and just kicked down each of the doors, like, wake the fuck up, kids.
She jumps in, wake up, shit heads.
Fuck.
What are we doing now?
Well,
Not so ready to play Dungeons and Dragons now, are you fuckers?
Robert needs to go to the fucking bank.
Kaelin curls further underneath the blankets.
To go find somewhere to watch Lilith again. Because it's been 2 weeks.
Lilith needs a bath.
Kaelin needs a bath, probably.
We all need one, probably.
Well, I went swimming. I had a bath.
You probably had baths during your travel. You didn't...
I don't care.
I mean, it's pretty easy to find...
It's fair, though.
Kaelin doesn't do anything.
Lilith might need a bath.
I'd say Lilith needs one.
Penn waited a little bit after Noah fell asleep to check and see if he sleeps curled up like a dragon or not.
Does he?
Yeah.
I watched his face while he said that, and I swear to God, he just on the spot whether or not that happened.
Yeah. Most of the stomach, I can't talk.
None of us can talk.
Most of the stuff I come up with is on the spot, pretty much.
That's the best way to
do
it.
I got so mad last session because I forgot to fucking stab you people.
It's okay, you have all day to do
it. I was going to mention it, but I couldn't find it.
Anyway.
Stabbing.
That's okay, you can just stab us 4 times today now. That's way better than last time.
I mean, you could have stabbed him the 4, it's been 2 weeks.
I like to think that you stabbed us like every day, just like to wake us up or something.
Hey guys,
absolutely.
You could have stabbed each and every other party member,
except for Noah.
Including Noah. Well,
it would have been an interaction if she stabbed Noah.
Boy, oh boy,
it would have been some kind of.
Noah's the McFucking worst, and I'm gonna as
bad egg boy.
I veto that.
Just smite him.
Thank you, God.
Suddenly, just goes brain dead.
Lightning just like strikes suddenly, and it's weird because you're indoors, but Noah dies. His weird half dragon heart just suddenly stops. Anyway, it's Dungeons and Dragons time.
Mm-hmm.
And we have no fucking clue.
Kaelin ducks underneath the blankets.
I need a bank!
Merit's sort of.
I know what I'm doing!
Jazzily.
I need to find a bank.
As you'll sort of rise, in reverence because you're sharing a room with Margaret. Margaret is not in the room.
Oh.
But yeah, you
fall asleep on top of the pile of money, reverence.
She did.
I like to think you margrated
fucking
from...
fucking dragon?
Margrated? Whoa. Migrated from bed to the money pile.
Yeah. It just... Somehow she got there in the middle of the night. She wakes up on the pile of money. It's a good way to wake up.
It's a little uncomfortable, but it's worth it.
It is. Just, exactly.
Fill a whole tub with it. And just slowly sink in.
I don't think she would because she's not my mom. But did Margaret leave a note or anything? She's probably...
Margaret, no. You, like, look around. Her stuff is here. She's okay. Not.
She didn't up and leave us. She just went somewhere.
I mean, yeah, her money's here.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, man.
Her fuck ton of money is still here, yeah. You slept on it.
80,000 gold.
God.
I look very nervously at the money. What?
Wait, what?
What?
Oh, I said, who can say that he slip on top of 8,000 gold?
Me, I can.
Exactly.
I'm the one. I look nervously at the money.
Get closer to your mic, you keep cutting out.
Thank you. both scooted a little bit closer to it. Anyway, do I have to say what I said again?
Yes.
Yes.
I don't know what you said. Looked really nervous about the bunny, but shut it in there and just like pat the door a little bit. Make sure it's locked like 3 times.
I mean, yeah, okay. I was gonna say maybe you've locked yourself up, but no, you have.
I would have a key in the room.
I know. Look, I've been playing Pokemon for 10 hours.
Now the question is, do I want to fucking knock on everybody's door and be like, get the fuck up? Or do I just want to, like, leave?
Merit is just jazzily, like, packing whatever he unpacked, like his books, putting them back, getting ready for the day.
Merit, all you gotta do is just pat, Caitlin on the head, and then she'll get out of her pile.
Actual cat she is. Anyway.
Noah, do you eat eggs, or is that weird?
He hasn't even waken up yet.
No, I like to think Noah woke up by now, but he goes, yeah, I eat eggs. It's fine. It's not weird.
Huh.
For me. I eat mostly, like, plants and veggies and stuff.
Eggplants.
Fuck, Penji, that was good.
That was good.
I love you.
I love you.
Oh. I was not ready for that.
Okay.
I wasn't either, and I said it.
I love when that happens. You just say it, and you're like, oh, wait. Egg. Plant?
Plant. He goes, yes. Yeah.
We've established that the walls are thin. So, I fucking, like, knock on their door.
Ours? Which one?
That was so real. Yeah,
Penji's. Pen and... Snoa?
Snoa? Looks over at the door, and he gets up and opens it.
Fuck.
He's naked.
You're, like, sitting next to me right now, and this is weird.
Like, as soon as I said that, I look right over at Siren.
Uncomfortable playing Dungeons and Dragons in the same room. Like,
you guys have to stare into each other's eyes and roleplay.
I won't. He's looking at me very intently. And I won't.
Chance, you have to get up on a chair to be 7'5".
You have to stand up right now and just stare down at Siren.
I always forget he's that fucking tall.
He's just obnoxiously tall, and I never forget that. It's ridiculous.
Reverence says, I heard talking, and I'm going out.
Good morning, Reverence. I'll come with you. Friend.
Good morning. Okay.
Pen, you are like a bell upon my ear. I love it.
I just hit the mic with a bell.
Pen is so pure.
Oh,
I love Pen. Reverence gladly welcomes you along.
Yes.
Yes.
I mean...
We established the walls are thin, so even if Merit can't hear what's exactly being said, he hears some sort of sound. He sort of prods Caitlin. Sort of.
What?
I made that sound because I assume she just like bolted up, and which makes Merit flinch. It's like I think we're going. I think we're going to get... If you care, get your stuff. Okay.
I slither out from underneath our blankets.
But Noah asks Reverence, where are you going? Like, where are you planning on going?
I need to go to a bank so that I can walk with all this money in my hand.
Okay.
Our fantasy bank's a thing.
You don't want it to get exchanged into platinum.
Okay,
so that you will not
that might have to deal with such a
okay,
heavy
I'll,
fucking sack
I'll
of gold.
Along. He was gonna go watch
to
Lilith first. I mean, I watch Lilith
like
first. But yeah, he'll tag along.
Me. At this point, Merritt has like exited his room, just looks over, is like, are we heading out? What are we doing?
We have a plan for the day. Kaylin calls from stretching.
To the bank.
The bank?
I'm going to the bank.
Bank.
I need platinum, not 3 sacks of gold.
Should we ask Margaret if she wants us to take her gold too?
She was not in the room. I assume she is downstairs.
She's not here?
Breakfast. All of her stuff was there. She was not.
I could go for breakfast. And Kaylin just walks past everyone.
Yeah, I'm going upstairs.
Yeah.
Alright. Are we sure Margrave's items are all fine?
I locked the door.
Alright.
She kind of puts her hands up like, what else do you want?
Merritt, by the way, you have the key.
Yeah, Merritt shrugs. Takes a moment. Locks. I almost said locks the hotel room, but it's wrong
term. This is
term.
So domestic.
It's the inn room. And
Merritt, you have the key
on.
Card.
Yeah.
You have it. Let me
I'm going to the pool now.
And the key goes somewhere in his vest. Which, thinking about that, he also double checks for the chess piece.
Do they have a weights room here? Because
get strong.
They do act no.
But you gotta get strong.
The chess piece is there.
Okay. He's paranoid about it now.
No, it's there.
Please. Don't make me look at around this fuck ass big city and more for
oh,
the chess
no,
piece.
You dropped it at some point. Where is it? No.
Merritt fucking would. Okay, anyway. He would. It's. Please don't do that to us.
You just have to duplicate object. Done. Boom.
But it could be like anywhere within the distance we traveled. Okay, anyway, we're going downstairs.
Downstairs to see if there's bacon.
Merritt's just going. Merritt's following my lead of just being drowsy this time.
So you go downstairs, there's a free continental
like
breakfast, sausage, eggs, biscuits, the whole works, continental breakfast.
This is a nice inn. We should stay
yeah,
here more often.
Dude.
I mean, we're in the capital.
Everyone, there's not a lot of people down here, like, it's semi-early, like, it's not super early, but it's morning.
It's
I don't
like
know how that is.
8, 9, some
yeah.
shit.
Is Margaret in here?
No.
I go up to the innkeep, dude.
Let me fucking describe the scene.
Innkeep person. Whatever, fine. Fucking describe it.
You go down here to the continental breakfast. Everyone is, no one seems, like, happy? Like, everyone seems pretty down.
Oh, no shit.
At the very least, somber. just sort of, it's very quiet. Like, there's no one talking, even the people who are in groups. And, yeah, you walk up to the innkeeper. He's just at his desk. He looks sort of distant.
I kind of tap on the desk to get his attention.
He looks up.
Have you seen a woman and a wolf travel through here?
Today. Just like slowly squints.
She wasn't in the room.
We would like to know where she went. Could you point us in a direction?
I'm going to grab some breakfast and pay for my breakfast and such.
Yeah,
and
I
got
in
a corner.
Yeah, they can go eat breakfast.
I ate breakfast.
The innkeeper sort of nods slowly, like, sighs and pushes his hair out of his face. And his hair is, like, thinning. It's not a lot of hair. And, nods slowly and says, yeah, she walked out earlier. It's still dark out.
Which, do you know what direction she went? Are they both, there's just the one door.
She walked out the front door.
Listen, because it's a stable door, fuck you. Okay.
Great.
That's it. I go eat breakfast. Thanks.
You're welcome.
So Kaylin's eating breakfast, just shoving it basically down her gullet.
Merritt's also eating, but not that fast.
Paris is not eating that fast, but there's a lot of food on her plate.
And stares at Noah.
Are you like holding it in your hands right now?
Can I give an egg of
a head voice? Hey, is this you?
Can I give this egg to you in this trying time?
Merritt notices Pan and just sort of squints but says nothing.
No one kind of looks at Pan and squints. And
I offered. I'm guessing that.
Kind of. After he gives this, like, realization face, and then he just looks unamused.
Pan eats the egg while staring at Noah.
This is a threat.
Noah's not breaking contact, like eye contact with Pen, like reaches over and grabs an egg. It just kind of starts it down, doesn't break eye contact the entire time.
Listen, I'm imagining that Pen grabbed a handful,
straight up Holiday Inn lobby.
Handful of scrambled eggs. And just held it. Shoved their hands into the scrambled eggs and just took some. And no, looked at Noah.
It's canon that Penn likes their eggs raw. Like, this has come up already.
Penn's a freak.
I was gonna say, Noah just grabbed a whole fucking egg and shoved it down.
I don't think they're just gonna have eggs raw sitting at the Continental Breakfast.
Why not?
Why not? Are there raw eggs?
I was imagining, like, sunny side up.
Delta, are there raw eggs?
There's not. This is nuts.
Are there boiled eggs?
Yeah.
Okay, there. Pen ate a whole boiled egg.
I just want to say that I'm imagining that everyone's at, like, there's a booth or something. Like, we're at, like, fucking Denny's or some shit.
Waking up in a Denny's parking lot.
I like imagining that it's like a buffet style thing, and Noah and Pen are standing on opposite sides of the buffet table, getting food and just eating eggs.
That's also what I'm imagining.
But as like he eats the first,
scrambled or boiled, whatever the hell. That's probably the first.
I'm telling you straight out, this is a fucking fantasy holiday.
Okay. This is gonna be the first proper breakfast Merritt has ever had. There's no way he has had sausage or like eggs cooked in this fashion.
Oh, have I ever told you at the time that I almost died by eating bacon? I was at a Bob Evans. I got like a plate of bacon because I was like, I need bacon in my life right now. And I was too young, so I was like, I'm gonna fucking have bacon. I eat the bacon, I almost die.
Choked?
Because I choked on my bacon.
That's impressive.
I lost a tooth on a breadstick once. Anyway.
Jesus.
I was like 10 and I died.
Careful when you're eating.
I almost ate my tooth once.
Oh my god.
Oh.
Oh, God.
This is a bad line of conversation.
Anyway, back to the Holiday Inn.
Fantasy Holiday Inn.
Pointing that out, KR, because I totally forgot that Noah's, like, tall as shit, the Pen's, like, tiny.
Yeah! it's just amazing!
By the way, Noah Kaylin towers. Is sitting at a table and frantically trying to get you guys to sit down at the table with her.
Banging on the table.
Merritt's just getting more amused. Like, he's already sat down, and he's just more amused at Pen and Noah being disastrous.
Pen, Noah, come here!
Reverence is slowly eating her very large plate of food and just watching Pen and Noah.
They're just standing there, shoving eggs into their mouths, unblinking.
Kaylin gets up and says, "Stop being weird. I know I'm weird, and you guys are being extra weird."
Merit Fulon cracks up now.
How's the intern feel about this situation?
Shit. Yeah, there is like an attendant in this room who has just been like, huh.
This is my life now.
This is happening for a long time.
It's like 3 straight minutes. It's horrifying.
just straight egg eating.
I go between them.
Eye contact.
I walk between
the table.
Guys. No, I was thinking. Never mind. I thought they were next to each other, not across the table from each other. Because I was just thinking
said,
that they
like,
were
across
next
the buffet.
I was just thinking that they were right next to each other. I was gonna walk up and like go in between of them, whether it's tails or not. Just reach out and just trying to break eye contact from either one of them.
just grab bacon. Faces.
Just grabs a whole handful of bacon and just like, you guys are weird, and shoves some of it in her mouth.
One hand in the bacon, one hand on the prize.
Y'all have gotta stop shoving your grubby hands in this food!
Pretty much none of us have proper table manners. It's probably
Ellen does. She doesn't want to use him.
It's probably good fortune that Merritt figures out silverware, because I imagine he's using silverware, but he doesn't usually use it. He's probably been watching Kaylin if she's been using silverware.
She's been using silverware. It's just this one instance. She's like, I'm just gonna fucking stop, guys.
Perfect table manners.
Penn grabs a plate of eggs and sits down.
I thought you were gonna start a food fight for a second. I was like, oh, Jesus Christ.
We all sit at a big table.
They're good.
Roll initiative.
Roll
we all sit at like, a
big innkeeper table. Joins the fight.
Let's not get kicked out.
We're going to get kicked out somewhere sometime. It might as well just
not
fucking
right
be now.
This
now
is
over
true.
Because Kaylin would just respond to, like, if that was actually said in character. Of the whole, like, we're going to get kicked out someday.
It wasn't
she would respond, well, she would have responded with, I've been kicked out of plenty of places, and this is the best place, and I don't want to get kicked out of it.
Fantasy Holiday Inn is the best.
Anyway, we spent like
we do not get kicked out of
talking inns. About breakfast.
Yeah,
it's this the most important meal of the day.
It is.
Yes.
Serving it up Gary's way.
So.
Noah and Ken are going to get like a lot of protein for this meal.
We're going to be so chock full of energy. It's going to be great.
And then around noon, it's just going to be like bad.
For real.
We made mistakes. No. And it was eggs.
It was only eggs.
Hey.
Eggs?
Kaylin is going to try to shove some bacon in her pocket for later.
I mean, yeah, you can do it. No one
just
stops you.
Straight into your pocket.
Just
that is super unpleasant. Some yeah. People give you looks at this.
Yeah, I think they're like,
my bacon for later, shut up.
Like, at this point, between Penn and Noah, you have attention from, like, almost everyone in
I
the
was
room.
Sitting at the table.
No, just the whole commotion and, like, you're sort of all a group.
Our group has
And then
been
you
out.
Come up yeah. here as well and are just, like, shoving bacon in your pants. And people are like...
This is my pocket bacon.
Pocket bacon.
At this point,
shut up.
Noah eventually Why? Does, like, break eye contact.
Don't
and,
judge me.
Like, kind of, like, slowly turns toward, like, Kaylin. Just...
Hello?
Ever.
Maribel's voice is fucking losing it. Maybe not like real loud, but he's been smiling the whole time because he's like, oh, these people. So Reverence, well, he's still smiling, like, do you see Reverence, these guys?
Reverence is also grinning a little bit. And, like, chuckling. Because this is funny shit.
Yeah.
Don't judge me.
We are going to get kicked out. Or at least we're going to be judged every time, anytime we come back.
I'm going up to my room.
None of us will regret it.
Perhaps we should finish our breakfast and leave.
Yeah.
Reverence says that.
You at least have errands. Yeah.
Nice.
Alright. You all finish your breakfast wherever you want to finish your breakfast. Gotta escape the egg boy's judgment gaze.
I eat breakfast alone upstairs.
You smell like bacon.
Good smell.
Oh god!
Good smell.
You're going to get attacked by dogs! Oh, you're going to have to fight for that bacon!
Yes! Let them come.
Let them come. But yeah, you all finish your breakfast. You amazingly don't get kicked out of Fantasy Holiday Inn.
We're lightening
get the feeling after all of that. Standards are kind of low at Fantasy Holiday Inn.
We were trying to lighten the mood. By being assholes.
That's this entire game so far. Anyway, barring Ben, maybe, considering they start the egg fiasco. Anyway,
they were just eating and bonding with Noah. I don't know what you're talking about.
That was, it was the best bonding experience.
You guys are gross. Caitlin says with bacon pockets.
That's a gross bacon girl says.
I want Caitlin to be known as bacon girl.
Has Marg Grey appeared by the time we're finished eating?
We find a bank. I mean, Merritt doesn't know what the fuck a bank is, so he can't help, but...
Pointing at a trash can. Is this a bank?
Yeah. Yes.
Caitlin, do you come back down from the room?
You guys have to come get me.
Noah goes up.
Reverence isn't going anywhere.
Egg boy.
Knocks on the door.
Yes.
I'm sorry.
Caitlin gets up, opens the door, and says, "It's okay, egg boy."
I'm sorry.
Weird.
And Noah tries to go in for a hug, even though she's like all bacon greasy.
Hugs, yes.
Noah, you smell like bacon.
Yep.
This is a status effect now.
I smell like
a legitimate question.
Attack my dogs.
I'm gonna put it in chat.
I'm sorry. I was reading. I don't... Oh does... no, she's upstairs just sitting in front of the door!
Wait, what?
So... Merritt has both keys. Caitlin didn't take a key. Merritt has both keys to the room. He locked the room! So Caitlin is just sitting outside!
Oh!
He's so sad!
Dwayne is locked in the room. We need to get Dwayne.
I told you, get your shit. Please.
Yeah, sure. Give me a second.
Was Reverence hatched from an egg?
Reference? I mean, you have no point of reference.
Oh, God!
Oh.
You could possibly be hatched from an egg.
She says, after Pen asks, she says, I don't think so? Maybe. She looks very, very confused, and like she's thinking really hard.
That laugh was both me and Merritt.
New egg boy? Reverence's mind.
Reverence's mind is just egg? Question mark.
It's like the bees card.
Does Reverence is egg?
The rumor come out.
God, let's go somewhere.
Yeah, assuming we've collected our resident barbarian.
So no sign of Margaret so far.
As you all step out the front door, which is what I was waiting for. Margaret is actually outside, and she's talking to this group of dragon.
Yes, exactly.
Here I go. Enhancing. Nice. Ooh, nice. Hey!
Oh! You!
You!
I know you! Well, I don't know you, but I've seen you.
Who it is?
He!
Hey! Oh, he's not dead!
Oh, yeah! Chance, were you even...
Chance has no idea.
This guy, wait, this guy right here.
Did he
here,
fall down a hole or something?
No,
that wasn't him.
He vanished like
first.
Was it? Yeah,
he was
in like
the first
to go. Game. Yeah. Like when we were in a goblin cave, and when we finished grabbing the orb from that cave,
people said that he was missing.
Do we recognize him? Those who were there.
Yeah, I mean, how many dragonborn have you seen in your day, Reverend?
Few.
Was that the person that Bess was worried about?
Yeah.
Make a history check.
A history check?
What? Yeah,
I mean, your own history.
Let me see. Did I get... Yeah, I got that right. I'm not used to doing
any of you can make history checks if you want. Oh, well, not any of you. Reverence, Pen, and Merritt.
I mean...
Merritt's probably going to think about it. He's...
Reverence doesn't care.
He's not going to think hard enough, but he'll think about it. Screen, that looks familiar. I have no idea.
Pen, you don't know this person's name, this dragonborn. You remember Bess said Dimas.
Okay.
And I just go, hey, I remember this guy.
Margaret is talking with Greta, but they all look up as you exit the inn, and Margaret sort of, like, stands up a little straight and goes, oh, those guys.
By the way, what Margaret saw, if she turned around fast enough, of the whole, like, everyone walking out and then Caitlin just whispering to Merritt and just darting back inside and coming back several minutes later.
At the acknowledgement from this group right here, the outside group, Merritt just nods like, oh, hi.
Merritt just stands there.
We've seen you before.
There it is. I'm glad we have one of these in our party.
I'm glad we have one of these.
It just holds Pen up proudly.
You know what I fucking mean, too. You know what I mean.
Weren't you at the wish thing? Pen gets too close to the dragonborn.
Just
hold on,
staring
I can fix
up.
This.
Not quite that close.
There. Are you happy? this dragonborn sort of looks at you, and then, like, sort of, oh, God, as you get closer and closer. But,
they stop, like, 2 feet away.
That's different than they get too close.
2 feet is not close.
That would require climbing this dragonborn if you got too close.
I imagine you're holding this dragonborn's hand if you say you got too close.
I mean, what if Penn isn't holding someone's hand?
I mean,
even strangers
are not holding their hand. It's a little too forward, even for them.
The dragonborn squints at you for a moment, and then this sort of recognition crosses their face, and they go, oh, yes, you are from that thing. And your friend, oh, yeah, no, I remember you.
I love this accent.
This is a right. good accent!
Really, this is top.
Good!
No!
And, Greta turns to Ysoria and says, oh, you know these people? They all have this. They're ready for it. They don't. Vaco does it. Ysoria goes, yes, they were at that thing I went to, remember? And then Greta goes, no, I fucking don't. I'm asking you.
This is good.
And Margaret laughs and says, I saw you. And Greta turns back to her. Oh, so you also know them. Well, I guess fucking everyone knows each other, whatever.
Who are you, fucks?
It's...
Okay, well, not like that. Damn it.
Who are you, fucks? Margaret sort of goes, it's fine.
Kaylin just basically falls down. I'm like, who are you people?
We don't know each other. Like, I don't even know your name. I don't know their name. And Greta's, okay. Well, there's a lot of people here now. My name is Greta Medeni. These are my students, Gudil Ysoria and Eveko Wolf.
I love everything right now.
This is so good. And I'm so immersed.
Very immersed.
Very close steps forward. Not as far as Penn did, but like to where he's a part of this active group that's talking. And sort of gives a small bow and goes, my name is Merritt. And that's Penn.
Penn waves.
Vega waves.
Yes. I love this dragonborn.
Side check for me real fast. Anyone who wants to.
Well, I mean, Merritt's...
Kaylin is right now feeling the feel of I ate too much breakfast.
Yo!
Yo.
Damn it, with my 6 proficiency!
Yo.
Merritt, no, it pen.
20, nice.
You even if you haven't seen like a lot of Dragonborn, you can tell Eveko he looks like a teenager.
Aww.
He does look like a teenager.
He does. These
Gudule and Greta? 7'5", easy. Maybe taller. Eveko, maybe a little lower than 7.
You did good at making him look like a teenager.
You did. Yeah. So precious.
But yeah. Good
deal. His tails. Which is also true.
Yeah, they all have tails. Good deal sort of waves a hand and says, it is a pleasure to meet you. And Eveko says, hello, sirs.
No!
Oh! Oh!
Chance, what? You're screaming and you don't even fucking know.
Scooch.
What?
I just saw from fucking Adventure Zone that you refuse to watch.
I don't refuse to watch it, I just don't have the time.
Fuck you. Yeah, you do. You don't do shit.
Hey, Chance. Same. Anyway.
Margaret sort of, like, turns to all of you and says, do you want to introduce yourselves? Or do I need to?
I'm Kaylin.
Oh. Noah, like...
Kaylin basically raises her hand and just goes, I'm Kaylin.
Yo.
Noah kind of, like, very, like... What's the word I'm looking for? Like... Not serious or...
Solemn? Polite.
Dignified?
Yeah, yeah, in a way. Kind of goes up to him and says, hello, nice to meet you. My name is Noah Kondralis. And he kind of puts his hand out for a handshake.
And this is Jackass.
it's basically Jackass. Our group.
It is Noah, and I'm Kaylin, and welcome to Jackass.
Grata sort of like looks at your hand oddly for a moment before taking it and shaking and retracting her hand.
Yeah.
Slowly wipes down her shirt.
Not that you can tell. Oh.
And then after that, he just kind of backs up.
After that happens, Reverence just looks at all of them and says, I'm Reverence. And that's it.
I'm trying to stand really close to Reverence because I smell like bacon.
Are you afraid?
Lilith is smelling you all down. Not all of you, Noah and Kayla.
Reverence smells the bacon and has a distinct face of disgust. And is like looking at Kaylin.
What?
Just like wrinkling her nose.
What?
You smell like bacon.
Well, I ate bacon, so...
You smell like bacon because you have some in your pocket.
Why are you out me like this?
Vaco is struggling to conceal a laugh.
Please take at least 2 steps away from me.
I take 2 tiny steps away.
Reverend sighs. Defeatedly.
By this point, Merit's looking behind at the girls. It's just so smiley, like, oh dear.
I'm a disaster. Get used to it.
Reverence turns away from Kaylin.
Margaret turns back to Greta and says, yeah, they're that. recruits and friends of the guild helping me. They were helping me. And Greta sort of nods and goes, I said she goes, but she doesn't say anything.
She nods.
She nods.
I'm sorry.
Speaking
was...
of.
Sorry.
Merit looks over to Margaret and goes, Reverence had some sort of plan before we leave to do here, I think. That's why we started heading out.
I simply wanted to have most of my gold exchanged for platinum.
Greta snorts. And. Sort of, like, crosses her arms and says, good luck with that. All of the banks are closed. Most places are.
Reverence looks crestfallen.
What? Oh, have the city collapsed?
Kaylin slowly pets Reverence on the shoulder.
So fucking heavy.
I can carry it.
Avaco, I love your robes. It looks kind of like my scarf. I'm a fan.
Reverence squints at Kaylin.
What? I'm just trying to be nice.
Are you going to... Can I trust you?
I can barely trust myself.
See, that doesn't help.
But with money, you can trust me.
Hmm.
and hands Caelan.
I'm sorry,
yeah,
I can't.
Exactly.
What?
It kept on cutting out.
Oh shit, I'm leaned further away from the mic.
Yeah.
Sorry. We're sharing.
That's why I got yeah? I can bet. You can always hear me. Yeah.
Okay. She looks Caelan dead in the eyes and says, "If any is missing, I'll kill you." And then hands her the sack with 5,000 gold in it.
By the way, Caelan goes, "Please do," and it has this like shitty grin and grabs the money from you.
Great.
Because Caelan is gay!
Reverence looks confused and uncomfortable.
Aveco, at you talking about his robes pen 5 minutes ago. No. It's okay. Sort of like rolls his shoulders and like pulls his robes up a little and smiles a little and says, "Thanks, I made them myself."
Ah! Honey. Oh, they look so good.
Do they? I just wasn't sure. I mean, there was like stitches here. It's a little weird,
they
you know. And
perfectly.
Then there's. I mean, this hem isn't great. It's a little long.
Penn starts pointing at patches that they've done on their own clothing.
Oh my god, you're so good at this.
I love everything. It's so pure.
I want to be best friends with him.
I want to be best friends with everyone.
Two peers collide. What happened?
We all die.
Let me eat
this. This is what came to mind, and I had to. All right.
Don't worry, I thought about it too.
Margaret sort of turns back to Greta and says, "So, like, about that city thing collapsing, like, what happened?" And, Greta sort of just sighs and says, I fucking wish I knew. The city, we've been having, like, tremors lately, and we've been monitoring. They were very mechanical, almost. They happened at the same time every few weeks or whatever, but this was unscheduled and extreme. We've been digging under the city to try and find it, but there was, well, we didn't really get there in time.
Yikes.
Unscheduled?
Yeah, I mean, well, unpredicted, realistically. Okay. We did not scheduled.
You could always tell when it was about to happen, though. Up until that.
Yes, they were like every 2 weeks on a Tuesday or something. Everyone planned their fucking days around it. It was, oh, it's shaky day.
Huh.
Tie down your belongings.
Huh. Mm-hmm. Very, very curious.
Yeah,
were they? And there's presumably nothing under the lake either, or I guess it's too late to tell now.
Don't know. No one's gone in the tunnel yet. In fact, that's why I was talking to your friend here.
Oh. And Merritt looks over at Margaret.
Reverence also looks at Margaret.
Margaret smiles at you.
Penn continues looking at Aveco.
Aveco is also looking at you.
Good.
So, I take it our plans back to Mantra are further delayed. I mean,
listen, you guys, I'm not going to make you guys go down there with me, let's be real.
Ron says, I'm in.
But I am also your ride, and I'm going down that hole.
I'm also your ride.
I want to go down the hole.
Okay. I go wherever you guys go.
Too curious not to investigate. Also, I would rather you not die, even with reverence. Apparently being
what you Reverence laughs a little bit. Reverence literally laughs at even with reverence.
But I mean, he knows, he's like, the holy folks can heal, right? But you both could die. That's the point he's making.
Cleric, but I am no healer. I have one. I don't even want to have a healing spell prepared, but I do.
You don't have
the
to.
One.
It's not mandatory.
I
be that
like
damage cleric. Be the damage cleric.
Fuck. Don't encourage me.
You guys don't know. I actually have healing.
I was the last healer.
Fuck, here I go. I'm a damage cleric from now on.
Yes.
I mean, I was anyway, but now I can fully commit.
I mean, I have a problem where I want to be the healer, but Merit ain't got shit for shit. Anyway.
Can warlocks heal at all?
No. there might be like one or two spells somewhere in there. Merit ain't got
one hit point. Merit, you can heal one hit point with Goodberry.
Yes, that's it.
Isn't it technically like 10 heal points?
I mean, if I eat all of them, yeah. If someone eats all of them, yes.
It takes an action to eat each one, though.
Listen, yes. It'll be like a minute.
And you'll feel very fucking full. Because they sustain you for a full day. One berry sustains you for a full day. You would die.
You heal 10 hit points, but you...
you die of overconsumption.
Just instantly die, but at least you were fucking healthy.
Kaylin shoved 5 berries
you were
in your
too
mouth.
Healthy.
I'm dying.
God.
Were the quakes localized in the other part of the city, or did they reach here as well?
Greta turns to you and, like, sort of, like, takes a moment and be like, oh, much shorter
small.
Than I am.
You're way down there!
You're so small.
And she says, for the most part, they only contain them. We were sort of getting the brunt of it being on the supporting part of that shaking.
Hmm. Mm. Wow, the music is really tense right now.
I mean, we're about to adventure.
So Margaret sort of looks at all of you and says, so you're in?
I'm in.
Why I'm not?
In. Sounds like fun.
Noah?
Kill me for saying this. Noah goes, I'm ready to go down any hole.
Reverence!
I'm dead inside.
Goes kind of red.
And the laugh I just made was actually Merit, too. Alright. Fair enough.
Will you be coming as a Sevako? Pen is so enamored.
Sevako says, of course! I go wherever Greta says.
Hooray!
Hooray!
Oh, this is gonna just be an adventure, isn't it? Alright.
That sounds like the clips that they would take for a TV show for what's gonna happen next episode. Oh, it's gonna be an adventure, isn't it? Yep.
Next episode, Leandra dies somewhere.
No!
Somehow, miles away, Leandra dies.
No!
A dragon attacked.
Please don't encourage Delta. We don't need that in our lives. Again. Anyway.
So, Greta sort of smiles and says, I'm so glad you're all willing to go down the hole.
I give a thumbs up.
Glances back over at Noah.
Greta is looking at you, Noah.
You were so dignified like 2 minutes ago. My favorite thing is that Noah was so dignified like 2 minutes ago.
Hello, my name
right
is
back.
Noah Kindred, and I'm a freak.
That's basically it. I need to know how Noah feels about the Dragonborn. Like, that's interesting.
That's more why he was so.
That's
with
the
everything.
I took a mental note of it, but I wasn't going to say anything. I'm a dragon people.
Can the Dragonborn tell Noah's a dragon? God, I want to know everything about this.
Get ready for more pin questions. Pin cushions.
I was going to have him Hulk out before, like, dignifiedly, like, went up and shake the hand, but it's like,
that's
I don't
a
know
lot.
Why I should have.
But...
No,
it me was gonna any be day.
No,
it was gonna be worse. I was gonna try something worse, but I just fought against it.
Please show.
Thank you for being kind.
There's a child present now.
There's a child. Be good.
And this is why I don't even mention Merit's anything.
Oh no.
Except that he was raised by Faye. Anyway. Oh god. I only just looked at chat.
Kaylin's typing so angrily.
There's a glint in her eye. It does not say fun.
Are we leaving now?
Greta shrugs and says, is there anything you need to do?
Kill Noah, apparently. That's out of character. Out of character.
We still have stuff in the inn. Should we move it somewhere? Is there a safe place to put it?
I mean, we did lock the doors as we left, but... Kaylin, did you lock the door?
I locked the door.
Okay.
Here's the key. She holds out the key.
Merit takes it back, puts it in the pocket.
Noah, like, snaps right to Pan and asks, did you get the key?
The shittiest roommate!
There was a key.
Did you lock it? Oh no!
Oh, no.
Do
no,
either
just,
of you...
this distraught look like, oh shit.
Did you lock the door before you left, Noah? Pin?
I don't think so.
I didn't know there was a key. But I have all my stuff, so I'm okay.
I also have all my things.
Noah, I have all my stuff.
Just draws what he's doing and just bolts into the inn.
Reverend just looks at Margaret and says, your things are there.
I like how we're very specifically not saying coin. Just things.
Your things. It's all still in the room. I've locked it behind me.
And then turns to Grin and says, do you have anywhere safe I could put, like, a lot of money?
It's a lot of money.
And Greta's like, my home was fucking destroyed yesterday.
Oh, shit.
Oh. And Margaret's like, that's a good fucking, that's, okay. Do you have the key?
Yikes.
Reverence.
What?
Do you have the key?
I love the shitty roommate situation. Yeah. This is so good.
I have the key. She hands Margaret a key.
Margaret takes it and goes, I will be right back. I have to go grab my shit. I guess I'm just leaving that there. Don't tell anyone.
Make sure you lock it again.
Yeah, probably will.
You probably should have grabbed the key before you walked out.
Maybe. She's already gone.
She's walking further away.
Why didn't we leave before Noah got back? I'm gonna murder him.
And the key.
Well, I mean, we're about to go spelunking. We might need... we might need his hair as, like, a beacon. I don't know.
Kale's overlapping.
Even references Chuck. Even references
as he comes out, and I like to imagine just as this is happening, a wind gust, like, goes by, and his hair just smaller than
majestically.
The
nature proves my point. And I'm
the tunnel is underwater, right?
No, the tunnel is beside the lake.
Okay.
It goes underneath.
I was eating a pretzel.
Could you all walks over to you, Reverence and Merit, and says, so, like, that wish thing, how did that go?
Bad? Bad.
Bad?
Not great. It could have been worse. We could have died, but...
No wish.
No wish?
No.
So we did.
Margaret got a wish?
Margaret.
As soon as Pin said that, Merritt's face just went blank.
That was in character. Over Pen.
Do you even know if Margaret got a wish?
Yeah, I think...
Oh, wait, Pen might have not known that. Never mind. Ignore that.
Okay, yes.
They totally would have said it, though. Just know that.
Leandra knew, I think. I think Leandra was the only one that knew.
Okay, never mind.
Okay. I know. I think Merritt knew.
Merritt knew.
Yeah, because it was in the barn, and we took the first shift and talked about it. But yeah.
The Reverence says, completely thinking it's true, no, there was no wish.
And Merritt avoids the truth, saying, we didn't get any. Talking about him and Reverence and Pin. Talk about those present right now.
He
always is. That's what
he does. The guy who cut the sun out trapped us in a plethora of different places. Made us do a lot of things.
He sort of looks to you, Merritt, and goes, is she alright? What did you just... What? Sun out? What?
We're pretty sure it was an illusion. He was being very grandiose when we first encountered him. But
you were there in the tavern.
I was there. That's why I'm confused.
He put out the sun.
The windows were dark.
Okay. That's what we're...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Look, it's been a while.
It has.
And I have some other things.
Meanwhile, what you missed was a tower full of very strange puzzles. It was great. And magic.
It was bad.
There was a dragon.
And then there was a dragon.
You guys are like dragons.
And then there was a field.
Greta visibly just like puts a hand on her forehead.
Reverence looks like she's in pain.
Merritt says quietly to Greta, please just understand that's how they are.
Pen doesn't notice any of this.
Vika goes, we're kind of like dragons.
Yes.
Greta's like shoulders slump even more.
Merritt gestures over to Pen and Vanko and goes, well, at least they get along.
Yes.
Kaden's gonna fuck. Ed, anyway, this is Margaret.
Can't just say I have a great ass.
No. This is my ex. Great ass. And this is... I keep on forgetting the names of my... Sitars. That's the wrong word. Qatar. Comfort and joy. I love Comfort and joy.
Gudjul says... Well, that sounds like a lot of fun. Sorry, I missed it. I just didn't really want to go and fight the dragon.
Oh, there were two dragons.
Oh, there were two. That's just delightful, isn't it? That's just the greatest.
What happened to you?
Delightful.
You guys gonna fight dragons? Kaelin says from the ground.
Yeah. Well, we fought one.
There are sparkle eyes in her eyes. Like, she's doing sparkle eyes.
We avoided the second.
The other was friendly.
Friendly dragons.
Pin said that Marisur grimaced, like, debatable, but...
As he says friendly dragons, he, like, Noah just, he hulks out. Oh. Kind of way.
No, it's not in the city. You're nasty.
You're nasty!
As the winds are furling everything, Mary flinches.
I'm sorry, you don't just be
can't believe
scared.
You're a dragon furry.
Can't believe you're a scaly.
Can't believe you're a scaly.
We're staring at a bunch of scalies right now.
All these scalies look at you like, what the fuck?
And
he can do that. Like, Mary just...
Yes, he can do that. Reverend sounds
he's
like
egg
he's
boy.
In pain.
He's an egg boy.
Joel's just like... Huh!
He's weird. I don't like it.
You guys are freaks!
Yeah.
Joel just starts dying.
Reverend's just it out.
Merritt's grinning now, but like he also like adjusts his hat. Like, he's hyper-aware of, like, ah, we're so strange.
Hey, Noah. Touches her horns in a very, like, way.
Get closer to the fucking mic.
I'm literally right next to it. I can't
eat
fucking
the mic.
Get any closer.
Turn up the mic ball.
Just for it.
For the mic.
What did you just say? Excuse me?
What?
That was not.
It's
yet?
Been 2 weeks. There's extra soup.
Is that better?
Is it better?
So far,
as far as we can tell, you haven't said
you gotta
really
fucking talk
sentences.
For it. To
I mean, out. It should be fine. Was it fine last night?
Mostly, yeah.
What the fuck? Is it on the right setting, Chance?
What?
Is it on the right setting?
I'll test the other settings, see how. What about this?
This is worse.
Yes, that is worse. Oh god. Really
or
dramatic
this.
Music.
What's good?
What's this one?
I'd imagine this one would be slightly worse than the first one.
It kind of is.
Yeah.
And now we're back to the first.
Okay.
Well, now you just
it's
cut off.
That one. Yeah. Wow. Yeah. Fuck. It was. You were louder, but then it. You were. Now it was the first.
Go with the medium blank. One, the slightly shittier, but doesn't cut.
Hello.
Okay. I
Hello.
Guess.
Hello.
All right.
So Noah, where's Lilith?
She's by the cart. Or she should be by the.
No, she's here.
She's here?
Yeah.
Like, why? Okay.
He would have gone guard her.
Yeah.
Even if you hadn't, she'd probably come out by the time you started talking.
Yeah.
I'd stay near Lilith.
Well.
I love this weird dog.
Bob, let's go.
Weird dog.
Okay, hello. But does Lilith smell the bacon?
Oh.
Of course, everything can smell of bacon.
Yes.
She, I know,
Lilith
but like...
Lilith starts, like, nudging at your pockets.
No, mine. My secret stash.
Lilith wants bacon.
She wants no. bacon.
She snuffles at it.
She's
no,
like,
it's mine.
She's really trying to get
his
bacon.
I pull out one strip, and I hand it to Lilith.
Her eyes, like, just light up. And she just gobbles it down.
You'll get more later.
Well, I assume
she
we don't
starts
have any
wagging her
business.
Like the,
go ahead.
Like, her little butt. I just imagine like, have you ever seen a dog with like no
yes.
tail with a nub? I imagine that's what she has. And
Lilith is literally a weird dog.
Her whole back end is wiggling.
It's very cute.
Well, I assume
so
we don't have any in the city, so
claps her hands together and says, "Are we ready to go?"
I'm good.
Is Margaret back?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Margaret's here.
Okay.
This music keeps getting louder in my ears. Okay.
It does. Why is it doing this?
It's because this particular song, I assume we're on the same song, is really aggressive.
Kevin McLeod, can you fucking make music?
He just gradually turns the knob up for everyone in the world.
My cat keeps on licking me. Send help.
Shy, please. We're D&D-ing.
She's role-playing as Lilith. She? He. Forget. It's a Sharon.
Yeah.
Shy, you're being an asshole.
So, we do it?
Yeah,
we do it.
We do the thing. We do the thing.
We discuss things for about 20 minutes, and then we do the thing.
We go through it.
We do the thing, and then we sometimes roll.
If this tunnel is near the water, can I ritual cast water breathing on us before we head there?
You can.
I'm gonna do that.
Okay.
Let me ping that spell.
Meanwhile, I just look at my, I'm looking at my list, going, "Oh God, that's a good call."
Look at my spell list. Oh wait.
It's your spell list is your weapons, my and their list, damage.
My spell list is fist.
Muscle wizard. Muscle cast wizard. Fist.
Yeah. Kaylin with the muscle wizard shirts, but the sleeves are ripped off.
Hey, Goblin, what's the name of the city that collapsed?
What?
What?
The name of the city that collapsed.
Sonaris.
Cool.
I got a question.
You mean to spell it?
I mean, yeah.
I mean, that's always helpful.
Who had a question, Tom?
For, like, say we ran into combat, and I wanted to, say, grow my scales for my armor.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I don't imagine we're going to game, but should I, like, put, like, each part that's growing, like, into a cantrip instead of just having it written down here? Like, later on another time?
I mean, you can, but I don't know how well it'll work because it's really just changing like your AC.
Yeah. Okay.
So, I mean, if it helps you remember, go for it, buddy.
All right.
That's mostly what the sheets are. Especially if we were like actually at a table, but. Yeah. Now we got like actual digital mechanics that
yeah.
we have to fiddle with. Yeah, you mentioned cantrips, and I was like, oh yeah, I should make Merit has a inherent archfey pact thing that I could put as a spell.
Yeah,
I'll do that later. I won't ever remember to do it, but
I'll do that later. Never does.
Yeah, I mean,
Sword
I have
of fucking life.
I have it in. Yep, I have it in the features and traits. I just like it'll probably be more helpful as a spell.
Yeah,
that's kind of what it is. Yeah.
Yeah, features and traits. Oh yeah.
We yeah, can deal I mean, with that later. Yeah, and remind ourselves next Saturday. Good. And panic just before the game and
it's
put it
in.
Hall.
I can't believe I'm the only non-spellcaster.
In the hall.
So. This is the fly hole that was made for me.
is that the guy that we lost in the island? Anyway.
Yes.
Is. He comes back to haunt us. That's what this is. Anyway.
So, Margaret goes around and gets the card. You all pile in, except for Lilith. Dragonborn included. They are significantly more.
Noah like gets out and hops on Lilith.
It's still cramped. They are over seven feet.
Jesus.
So like, the way I imagine this cart is there like a step to, like, get in from the back?
Yeah.
Okay, Meredith's sort of right there holding on, just so there's a little more room. He's also sort of keeping watch.
Noah kind of, like, looks at Meredith like, dude, you want to just ride on Lilith?
Want to ride my bear?
Want to ride my bear, bro? Doesn't say that. But, yeah. Kind of gestures that there's enough space on here. Pretty big.
Merit shrugs, gets off the cart and goes over. And gets on.
Ken is going to sit on someone's lap.
I don't
Mine, please.
Someone.
Gonna sit on Reverence's lap.
Damn it.
She lets it happen.
Yes. They're content.
She makes kind of a face at first, but she just lets it happen.
It's gonna happen regardless.
So yeah. Here, let's
the somber music, though.
Pen's gone. Who's Pen?
We're going to our graves.
I can't believe they're dead.
I can't believe they're fucking dead.
I like us questioning who everyone is. Came from my sister, my twin being ass. Like, who are these people?
Oh yeah, earlier in the chat. I think I missed that.
KR, did you see all of our beautiful fan art?
Yes.
Good.
Wasn't it so good?
I was like, I can't believe I missed this. But I would actually end up getting my Tabba and putting too much effort. And then I will end up way too late.
I do, though.
Eventually, probably. Anyway.
I can't do poses, so I'm sorry.
That's why I haven't drawn them. I can't. I just draw people standing.
Arrow and Kaylin. Not Kaylin. Fucking
Kyra.
Too many K noises. I have too many K noises in my brain.
I'm so sorry.
I'm sorry.
Kyra's my fault.
Yeah.
So, you all pile in, start riding through the city. As you travel down the streets, you start feeling it again. That sort of like, oh shit, yeah. A city collapsed. Like, there are people sort of, like, everywhere. Not, like, even super crowded or panicked as it was yesterday. Just, like, a lot of people around, and they're not buying things. They're just standing around. There are, like, there's a few carts of people that you see go by who are, like, if you need shelter, come with us. If you have shelter, also come with us, you know? Just, like, trying to help anyone who they can. There's people who are looking for other people. And it's just sort of a bummer. It's a bummer.
Yeah.
And, yeah, most of those stalls you saw along the main roads before, they're, like, empty, closed off, you know, locked down, so no one steals their shit while this sort of crisis is happening. And you head through all the city streets, out through, fucking get my ruler out, this exit.
Let me zoom out. Okay.
Right here.
There.
And, you start riding around the lake with the guidance of Greta to about a quarter of the way around this big, as you realize as you're going around it. And there are people, like, actually camping outside of the city now. Like, there is tents and shelters set up all along the outside and the outskirts. And there are still more people out here who are, like, looking for other people and being tended to. And there are a few people out in the water looking over the ruins and just trying to, like, find anyone or anything that is salvageable.
Mm-hmm.
And, you make it around the lake, and you see it first, this sort of, like, mound of dirt that's been displaced, and as you come around to its sort of face, it is this structured tunnel that leads down, like very steeply down into the earth, and there are torches lit along the whole way. But Margray pulls the cart up, and you all hop out, sort of conglomerate around the opening of this tunnel.
Okay.
Please take the
I'm
focus
so
off
ready
me.
For this.
Oh, I'm like not ready for this.
I'm not saying I'm anything.
The only straight person in our group.
How does it feel?
But again, like, no one doesn't
care. No one doesn't care.
But is Noah straight?
That's the true question.
Mostly.
Shit, I hope not.
What? Isn't
but then he saw merit.
I have pointed out several times.
His wonderful hair flowers.
Merit is a gorgeous, gorgeous boy.
He's pretty handsome.
Merit is handsome. All of our characters are pretty attractive.
They are.
Yeah, no, I'm stressing the merit.
Kaylin is not.
Yes, she is.
Kaylin is beautiful. Two thumbs up.
No.
Thank you, Delta, for making all of our children so pretty.
Yes,
I'm the same.
Making them so pretty.
And they're also so cute in this icon. I still can't get over it.
Yes.
It's precious. Okay.
Okay, into the tunnel.
We're at the tunnel. Penn is very solemn.
Let's get in this hole.
So is Merit.
Merit's totally not thinking about Noah's ass.
Damn it, Delta.
Damn it, Delta. Me too.
Let's go.
Yeah.
Kaylin is ready to
Greta
go.
Greta sort of walks up to the entrance and says, "We don't know what's going to be down there. So be prepared for anything." And sort of just starts walking down the steps.
Mary sort of adjusts the quiver, still with no bow. You know, just like, all right.
Merit follows, I guess.
Yeah, Merit nods and follows.
Yep.
Can't get a letter to damn tunnel.
Kaylin follows with comfort and joy.
All right.
Also, I was going to type out, but like during that time, like Merit had his arms around. Noah like kind of held his hand.
Okay.
It's
happening.
It's happening.
It's happening. Please bring the focus off of me.
Penn is going to attempt to hold Avacha's hand as we head into the tunnel.
He lets you.
Yes.
That is sort of like awkward. Like your hand is all. It's crouching a little bit. It works out. You're going down the stairs.
Beautiful.
It just cracks me up. Noah's mostly straight, and there's a little asterisk. And then I'm like, well, fucking Merit doesn't care about the gender binary. You're in trouble now.
Okay, tunnel.
Yep.
Secret tunnel.
Can't believe these ranger boys.
Secret tunnel.
The ship name Ranger Boys.
Pretty much. That's what it's gonna be.
So, as you start descending, this is a well-crafted tunnel. Like, despite the city literally collapsing, seems for the most part, like, the deeper you go, it's still solid. There are a few, like, loose pieces of the ceiling have fallen, like little rocks, and you can tell there's like an indent in the ceiling. They're like the size of your palm or something. But there's no like cracks in the structure at all. Fine. There's torches along the walls as you go down, mm-hmm. and it gets darker, and Greta grabs one, and Avago grabs another.
So I have dark vision.
I think most of us do.
Yeah,
I'm pretty sure most of us have dark vision.
I think now that we don't have Leandra,
Margray.
Oh.
Actually, don't Dragonborn, do they...
I don't know about Dragonborn.
Yeah,
I was
going.
They do.
Let me check. Dragons, I'm pretty sure do, but I don't think Dragonborn do.
Races, Dragonborn.
No, they don't.
Yeah.
So they still they bring the torches anyway.
Okay. I remembered that because I remembered in Critical Role Tiberius would like, I cast light, and I was like, there's no
fucking
point. Yeah, it's no point except for, like, Percy. But anyway.
Poor humans.
I cast light.
I mean, there's torches. It's not dark.
I don't. Damn.
I don't. Never mind.
She's just gonna, like, awkwardly walk down the tunnel in silence.
Well.
I guess.
I'm not sure how many of us are feeling like talking after that solemn trip.
So did all of you live in the city that was destroyed? Does that mean you guys
did all of your lives get around?
Did all of your houses get lost? Like, wow. That sure is something.
Know that feel.
Does that mean you're all wizards is the most important part of that question.
Greta answers your question without even like turning back to look at you. She's in the front. I was a professor at the college there. I taught mostly Dragonborn, like these two idiots. I love you. But yes, I lived there. So most of my things are maybe gone, which is pretty cool. Penfolds. And,
Losing your home isn't that great. Kaylin pops up from the back.
Avago says, all of my things were in there.
You didn't have Dwayne. Do you want Dwayne?
What does that mean?
I hold out my rock. This is Dwayne.
I'm good.
Okay. I put my rock back.
Alright. It's good. I'm good. Got my clothes. On my back.
They're very well made.
Remus sorry, is just like, I've never had a home.
Yeah, losing Usaria your home
says,
stuff. Losing all your possessions actually really suck.
Merritt's not thinking about what could happen to his home. Anyway.
Merritt doesn't want to think about that right now.
Because it would have to be fire. Anyway.
Usaria says, mostly my things are gone, but I mean, things are replaced. Most of the people I cared about aren't dead, I think.
Let's not think about that. Let's not think about that, Kaylin.
Probably good. Back.
Kaylin hasn't had alcohol, by the way, in a while.
Greta says, yeah, that's a bit of a downer.
Yeah, let's not think about that. Let's just not think about losing anything right now.
But to answer your wizard question, which was the most important question, I am a sorcerer, though I dabble in other types of magic. The accent is slipping. The cracks are showing.
I mean, it's only almost like 2 a.m. for you, but listen, it's fine. after 10 hours of Pokemon.
10 hours of Pokemon, 4 hours of Dungeons & Dragons, living the life.
Honestly.
And she says, I myself am a sorcerer, but I taught many different professions. Isoria is a druid. I've taught bards, wizards, you name it, I've done it.
This music is really...
Wouldn't happen to know the name Brightwood, would you?
Jesus Christ, this music.
Brightwood. I would have to check. There are many woods.
There's a lot of wood in the world. Just
too many trees. Sorry.
I ask. I was thinking there was a scholar I knew with the surname Brightwood. I hadn't seen him in a while, and I was wondering where he might have gone.
Remember his first name? Merit. Do we know his last name?
No.
No.
Fuck.
Merit has not told any of you.
She's still looking at you like, what the fuck?
Do you know this scholar's first name?
Alaron. Alaron Brightwood.
Alaron. I could ask. I, again, primarily teach the Dragonborn at the city, but I know many professors. I apologize.
No, it's fine. I'd appreciate if you did ask, but after this, I don't know how long we'll be in the city, nor how you may contact me if you did know. But
we
it was
find ways. There is always ways.
No, it's just like
it's true.
Thick skin.
If you do ever come across the name, just try to let me know. I'd appreciate it.
Of course, in these trying times, we must help each other. Yeah, what the fuck was that about pigskin?
Pardon me? Cakeskin?
Okay, listen. You know how with cake, there's usually like the outside is like a little bit like
frosting.
No, yes. Fuck you.
The crust.
The crust.
The cake crust.
Cake.
Yes.
Yeah.
Where it was baked. Yeah. Cake no.
Skin. That's frightening. Oh, that is a frightening thought.
But
cake flesh. Yeah.
Just want to reiterate. No one knows Merritt's surname except Margray knows.
Nobody knows. Caitlin's surname either.
Yeah.
Literally no one knows Penn's.
Not even Penn.
Yeah. But yeah, just... And I've specifically done that. It's a full name thing. Anyway.
Stupid fairy shit.
Fae shit, yeah. Can't know the whole true name. You just know the first...
Okay, we continue down this tunnel.
Yeah. We've been continuing, but further
silence.
The awkward silence returns. Like an old friend.
Because Caitlin doesn't want to talk about losing people. Nope.
Yeah, Merit's just
talk about
it.
Don't. Just don't think about it either.
Yeah, they do also seem like sort of like, they are joking about this, but you can kind of tell it's, like, to deal with it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So you descend down, up and down, around, in between the tunnel. For a good while, and, eventually you can't see the opening back out. Like,
as
it is
we do.
Going down, as it is wont to do.
Is anyone else having flashbacks to the Minotaur? No? Just me? Okay.
I wasn't there.
I wasn't even in character, but, like, it's like, joke character. Because that's what I'm thinking. I'm waiting for the webs to come.
There's anyway. Just tons of... No.
And Pin turns back into a spider.
I'm ready.
Hand on the button.
Coffee and coke. Put me in
and quotes. Spider button.
Button it just the spider.
You know the blurry button of the guy slamming the button?
Yeah.
Blue button.
It's spongy and animal shapes.
Eventually the carved part of the tunnel opens into this natural cave, and Greta holds up a torch, and the cave isn't like massive. It's not tiny either. Like, you're gonna have to crawl at all. You can definitely walk through it, like all of you. But it's like it's around like a house heat ceiling type, like maybe 10 feet. And she holds the torch up and sort of like illuminates it slightly and turns to all of you and says, "This is where we stopped digging. We didn't really get to explore this too much, so get ready."
I've been ready.
Good.
Merit goes ahead and summons Snapdragon. Just no real fanfare, just in his right hand.
By the way, I just want to make sure that everyone else has seen this big black box.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah. Just want to make sure. Okay. Noah. You guys speak. I need to grab something real quick.
Okay.
But you just see Noah whip out two hand crossbows.
That's pretty badass. You're just...
Mary looks over at him and squints like, "Well, that's different." And then he just nods. Like, he doesn't actually say that's different, but just that's the look on his face, just like, "No." And then just nods and is like, "All right."
So Greta continues, you know, leading you into this cave system, and she's sort of like, there's like a dripping sound, but it's not like running water or anything. Or like,
it's just like, "Hey,
the cave is caving in and the lake is un—" It's just sort of like a damp cave feel. And she says, "We are under the lake. I'm not entirely positively sure, but I don't believe we are under the city yet."
Okay, I'm back. Sorry.
Perception check.
Yeah, I was just thinking, I was like, there's something I want to do here, but I don't know what. Perception would be good.
Gotta fucking doing remember that too. How to play Dungeons & Dragons.
I'm sorry, what's going on?
Perception! Oh, we're looking in this cave.
Nice. Okay. Good job, me.
Nice. I'm the lowest one here. Okay.
Well,
show-offs.
Yeah, except, perception. Except okay. Fuck you, guy.
Where'd I put it?
What do you see with your special eyes, all of you?
Tell me.
Jokes. I mean, I know I don't need it, but, like, does Lilith make one too? Make perception checks?
She can.
She has she any can. Way to communicate to you. Please.
She can't even communicate to Merit.
She can't even communicate to Merit. Shit.
We got a problem.
Can now.
Oh, well, yeah, for like an hour, if I think about it.
I feel so inclined.
I mean,
I just want to say the reason why I had to walk away is that I had to take the collar off my cat to go do practically really minimal first aid on him.
Oh, is he okay? Shy. Okay.
He's fine. He's just... He's
where he's
over,
really itchy, isn't it?
Yeah, he's over grooming and such, so his neck is bleeding, so I had to fix it.
Maybe.
He's highly allergic to fleas, so.
Lilith didn't see anything.
Didn't see shit.
I see fuck all.
Can Lilith see in the dark?
Let me see, does she have dark?
I mean, owls can.
I think she can. Yes.
Lilith sees the bacon.
I hand Lilith some bacon.
Yeah, she has dark vision.
You get a little bit more bacon, Lilith.
It's
again, it starts wagging her tail. A little nub.
Her butt.
But nub.
I mean, it's not important right now, but I assume Lilith gets advantage on some sort of like smell tracking later, if we need it. Ever.
Keen sight and smell. The yellow bear has advantage on wisdom checks that rely on sight or smell.
Oh, okay. Sight or smell, so perception and survival, probably.
So you had advantage on that, actually.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not super important,
again,
but
it doesn't matter
check,
a whole lot.
Yeah, I think Delta's I just say you see a tunnel.
But, I mean, but go I for just, it. Go the extra mile.
I just wanted to point that out, because it's a thing for Beastmaster Rangers. It's a lot.
Yeah.
Yeah, did we see anything, though? What did I see with my terrible eyes?
I mean, it is a tunnel. It is a cave system. For the most part, it's pretty straightforward. Like, there are curves and such, but there's no real, like, break-off in this cave. And it isn't, like, a massive, like, you can't see the walls cave. Like, it's pretty straightforward. There, you seem to be alone for the most part right now.
Okay. No cracks, marks, nothing.
Yeah. I mean, there is, like, condensation and, like, natural water and such. Because I imagine you are all looking out for that. Like,
yeah. That's why I said cracks.
But,
I mean, we have water breathing for the next 24 hours.
Yeah.
So.
Still, that is something that will crush you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I imagine when Pin finished casting that, they, like, tried going forth and high-fiving everyone.
Hey.
Finger guns. We both finger guns at each other.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I guess we go on.
Onward.
Onward, now. Up, downward, I guess.
Downward. Downward.
I was just checking what did cover ever, including one. So yeah, you continue through the cave. Let me sit and think on it for a little bit.
Okay.
It always makes me nervous when you go quiet, because I'm like,
yeah, I don't like
oh God,
it
are you
think.
Just thinking, or is there something really bad coming?
Thinking or scheming?
Exactly.
Both.
I mean, technically both, but... Who was that, and who was that?
Yes, whoa, I'm the demon!
Oh boy. Not again. God.
What do you mean?
Oh no! Again?
Pashmina returns.
What was Rizlan's voice again?
No!
Don't,
no!
Don't!
No!
Don't!
No.
Hello, I'm Rizlan.
No! No!
I'll bring out my pixie.
It's a pleasure to fucking meet you.
No!
You wanna fucking go?
Yeah, I wanna go with Rizlan.
No!
You know, if you just say Rizlan, I'm Rizlan, then you become Rizlan.
I'm Rizlan.
Get it. The hat's been passed. I'm free.
I've never been this sad in my life.
Now that I'm Rizlan, all the kisses. You get all of the kisses.
This is the tiniest Rizlan
you, I'm
saying.
Mask.
I am a mask.
Shrink.
You said I'm a mask, and I'm just thinking of the fucking the Touch the Skyrim episode that went out. Weird thing. They had the guy with just a mask.
Fucking
Let's go, please. Please, I might
yes,
do something.
Okay.
You walk for like several hours through this cave, and it's slowly descending. At some point, there is actually more, like, you can see visible running water. Like, there is a stream going through this cave that is carved through the stonework. Because it's been streaming for a while. It's on Twitch. You should check it out.
Oh, good.
Oh, God.
Not even a single pity laugh.
No? Not for that one.
There's a pity smile from my end, but you can't tell.
No, I frowned.
Listen. It's 2 a.m. I've been playing Pokemon for 10 hours.
Why did you do that?
Because I love Pokemon!
Me too.
You continue down. Eventually you get to this sort of flattened out area again. And, Greta sort of just, like, looks around this new, and this is a more open cave. It's still not, like, massive. Like, there's no, like, oh fuck, this is the Minotaur cave map. But it's starting to get bigger again. And, Gudule turns to you. Gudule? Greta turns to you. They both have G names. And, sort of... We've been traveling for several hours. Would you like to rest? Or something? I believe this would be an alright place. Perhaps.
I would like to perception check the area before I decide yes.
Go for it.
Yeah, same.
There.
Second round! Oh god!
I don't see
oh,
shit!
God.
Second
oh,
round! Guys. One's all along!
Guys.
Oh my god!
Guys. Guys.
Me and Merit are already asleep.
Yeah, we've already
rolled it with advantage.
Jeez, you guys. Come on.
Roll the wisdom for Lilith again. No, because
yeah.
You already rolled it once.
Oh, okay.
The next time.
Oh, so 11 again.
See?
Still
better.
Thinking about that.
Oh,
baby.
Thank God, Penn saved us. Okay.
Yes.
Better. Oh, thank God.
And me and Penn are both already sitting down.
Yeah.
You all actually like walk around. You're like, let's check this out. Let's just do this first. And you all like walk around the room. It's good. And Penn is like, the fuck?
Oh God.
You, Penn, you walk around. You examine this cave. It branches out here, actually. There are three openings across the room that sort of twist away, and you don't, you know, venture down very far, I imagine. But the room itself is fairly empty. There are bats in here.
Hmm.
Which strikes you as odd.
Oh. We're, like, really deep underwater. Not under water, but...
I mean, you are under some
yes,
water.
Under... you know what I mean.
We're
under, like, hours out from the entrance. That's
yeah.
A little weird.
Okay, this is out of character. This is out of character, but...
See all those bats?
I assume now that they've been pointed out, I see them. I just imagine.
I mean, you haven't. It, you do see them, but it takes a while.
No, that's.
Right there. See, look. Squint really hard. That corner.
Squints really hard. Oh, is that moving? Oh, yeah, that's a bat.
Yeah, they're like all over the ceiling. I'm surprised you didn't see them.
Oh, shit.
Oh, look at that.
This is out of character, but bats mean an entrance.
Yeah. No, that's what I was getting at, too. We're miles away from
we,
the initial entrance.
Really far from the surface? Do you want to ask him what's up? Talk to the bats, Merit. Talk to the bats.
I cracked up as a player because I was like, oh god, Merit's going to be squeaking at them.
Because
he does animal speech. Yeah. It's gonna be weird. It's gonna be great. I love my dumb son.
I love my idiot son.
He's not even that dumb, but oh god.
He's more clueless than dumb.
But yeah, he clears his throat and says to the bats, "Hey, excuse me."
Ah. This is echoing across as all the bats sort of begin to stir.
I'm sorry for disturbing you, but how did you get this far down? We traveled a little ways to get here. Me and my friends.
The bats sort of, like, after this immediate, like, ah! It, like, ripples through the group of bats.
It just sounds like everyone would hear the bats.
Oh yeah, no, the bats out. Are now very loud. The ones that initially woke up sort of like, what is that? What are these? What is that? The thing's not one of us. What is it? What are you? Hey! Hey! What does that mean?
It means we're shaped like this, and he holds out his arms.
You're weird!
Yes, I've been told.
You're weird.
We're just sort of passing through.
Hey, that guy's a big weirdo.
He's so weird.
Merit says to Pan over in common, the bats.
They say they don't know.
They don't know how they got there? Is that what you meant, Delta?
No, that was a joke.
Okay. I can see that they're bats, Merit. Where did they come from?
They're not very responsive. Give me a minute. I was just wondering.
Start squeaking harder.
Which is impressive because, you know, his bracers. His bracers hold down his shirt. Anyway. He goes, where, pray tell, did you all come through to land here? We came over from there, and it was a long trip. You guys usually sit in an entrance, don't you?
We came a long way. Didn't we come? Hey, Greg! We came a long way, right? Yeah, we came a long way.
Hey, Greg.
It just sort of nods in Greg's direction.
I don't know, we like sort of flew down, and then we went down, and then we went more down.
I mean,
Greg! Greg!
Merely so for Greg! So for a pin, and just shakes his head in this pack of bats.
Greg says we went pretty down. That's how you got down here, right? We went down.
I mean, this is under a lake. You realize?
Yeah.
I'm just saying. Okay.
A lot of things to eat. Things like water. I like water. Greg, do you like water?
No, I love it when we talk to animals.
Is there an animal?
Where he doesn't look at the bats now, he's just looking up at the ceiling like queens and consorts. Why?
We need a lot of slugs. You want some slugs? I can get you some slugs. Greg! This guy wants some slugs.
I'm good.
You sure? Greg's got the slugs.
Yes.
Man, he's got them slugs.
He
knows how to get the big ones.
And I appreciate it. I'm good, however.
Merit, are they saying why they're down here?
No, they said they just came down here. They said they're here for food.
There has to be food placed on the surface, right? It seems kind of weird.
There's just impressively big slugs down here.
Right.
And he says that in common with not even acknowledging that Pin has no context to that.
I'm just listening to this and like, what? She looks confused.
Merit continues and goes, is there not food that can be found, you know, further up? You had to fly this far down?
I mean, there's food up there. There's also a lot of shitty things up there. Greg, isn't that right? At this point, Greg flies over. He's right. It's shitty up there.
Hello, Greg.
A lot of particular of disturbing noises.
There's bats. There's things that are not bats. Like, I don't know what the fuck you are, but there's a lot of those things. There's bigger things?
People. A person. Yes.
I don't know what that... Just stop talking. Big slugs. Down here. We down here now. Big slugs for us. Upstairs. Bad things. Bad guys. Bad people. Bad bats.
No big slugs.
No big slugs. Boom.
I see. Well, my group will be down here for just a little bit, but we will...
You're gonna eat our fucking slugs?
No, we have our own.
You hear this shit? He's eating our slugs.
We are not...
The sort of, like, echo of fucking... across this bat.
Does Merit's squeak not echo of we are not?
It does, but they're all talking about this now.
Merit looks back at Pin and goes, I think we might have to fight the bats.
Merit goes, what did you do?
They think we're after their food, and I'm trying to tell them we're not. They're not getting the message quite well.
Why did you tell them we were going to eat their food?
I didn't! They assumed! These bats are very assumptive. It's terrible.
Assumptive? It never goes well when you people speak to animals.
Either way, I'm not sure we should rest under all these bats.
Hey! Your buddies want our slugs, too?
No! It's my favorite thing of Merit switching to animal, because, like, a single no is just another screech. God.
The bat from Ferngully is so good.
We have our own food we've brought with us. We're not eating anything you have. We're just also resting.
You can see Kaylin in the background just slowly put some bacon in her mouth.
Can I do a nature check to see how weird it is that there's a bunch of bats miles and miles under the surface? Because I'm pretty sure
you know
weird.
It's weird.
Okay.
Merritt's more or less taking their word for it, but he feels it's weird too. Like, he's not...
Thing is, I'm not... thinking.
Insight check the bats.
Insight check the bats, Merit.
You gonna insight check Greg and Eric?
I mean, I was thinking of doing a nature check in tandem if like Benji doesn't do well, but I'll fucking insight check bats. Fuck it. Can I?
Yeah.
Something tells me you're not lying.
No.
I'm pretty sure these bats are pretty mad about their slugs.
Thinking, like, we obviously aren't eating the slugs, but, like, if Lilith saw a stray slug, would she eat it?
She should probably not.
I gave her bacon.
I don't think bears are into slugs.
I don't think owls or bears are into slugs.
Owls might
owls
be.
Probably.
Owls eat rodents and, like, mammals and birds. No. Listen, man, I know my fucking owls.
They might eat really big bugs, but not slugs. Wait.
Well, it's really weird that these bats are down here, and even if they're just down here for funsies, I don't really want to get pooped on by a bunch of bats. Perhaps we should rest elsewhere.
I mean, there are areas of the cave where the bats are not.
I don't want to get pooped on, Delta.
I'm just saying, you could stay in this cavern if you wanted.
Just avoid the bats.
Reverence is already sitting down.
Kaylin has been sitting down.
I don't think Reverence saw the bats.
She didn't. She sees Merit squeaking uncontrollably and then talking to Ben, and she's listening and or reading lips of all of it, and she's just like, okay.
Yeah, you can read his lips as he squeaks, and it's like, what the fuck?
Those aren't words.
Gajula, Vako, and Greta are sat down. Like,
by this point, everyone else has taken.
They were already sitting.
By this point, everyone else has taken a short.
It's cold now.
I know. Like, I don't want
your there's like solidified grease in your pants.
I'm just thinking of the crispy bacon. You guys are thinking about like still soft bacon. I'm just thinking about like
no,
this thing is solid and I can break it over things.
Yeah, that is called still be jerky.
No.
No, I mean, there's a difference between really crispy bacon and...
I mean, crispy bacon gets soft after a couple of hours.
I don't care. My bacon.
Merritt just sort of crosses his arms, sort of squints at the bats and looks down at Penn and is like, I don't know.
Fine. Penn's going to sit down, but they're not happy about it. And they're going to keep watch. Just to make sure nothing weird's going on.
Merritt sort of shrugs and sits not too far from Penn, but a little ways from Penn and the bats. It's what to deal with the bats right now. And actually, like, would the party not hear all the rest of the bats sort of squeaking? Or, like,
no, hear everyone's that? No, heard the bats by now.
Okay.
I just got nat 1, so I'm already sing. I don't see shit.
We rest.
We do that.
Yep.
We do that.
Greta goes, so, like, who the fuck are you? Like, what do you do? What is your deal?
I have been called the... And she puts up quotation marks. She has the whole quotation marks thing. Drunkard?
That is not a good way to introduce yourself.
I mean...
Don't care, honestly.
When we met her, she was being cut off from the bar. She hasn't...
True.
...drank since then, but...
Yeah, I haven't. She, like, thinks for a second. At least not today.
Good for you?
You get a little pin from AA.
It's
been a couple weeks.
But I basically fight, that's what I do. I get angry, I fight, that's what I do.
Interesting. We are all magic users. So.
Me too.
Me too.
Yeah, you said that.
I did, I know.
I just sort of shrugs and he's like, I'm just a very pretty bastard with a magical bow and a few spells myself.
Who
not exactly.
Sorry.
Yeah.
I mean, technically, yeah.
Yeah, technically.
Who did she say was the druid? Was it somebody traveling with us, or?
Gudjul Usoria is the druid.
Cool.
Marmont just shrugs and doesn't say anything.
And, Kaelin points at Reverence, like, she has a knife that heals people?
I do.
Reverend to me. heals people.
Yes, would you like me to stab you?
Yes, no, actually, this sounds amazing.
Really?
I'm very interested.
Reverend looks very excited.
Reverend's eyebrows go up and he smiles like, oh god. Here we go.
May I see the knife first?
Yeah, she gets out the forgiving edge and hands it to Greta.
Greta sort of, like, inspects it, like, pretty thoroughly. And, like, her face goes from, like, what the holy shit?
Rabbit's looks increasingly excited.
Please stab me with this.
Let me just get it real quick. Fuck, it's not, like, in my weapons.
Oh, you fucked up.
I didn't know how to put it in.
Okay.
Probably part one and part two would be my guess.
Listen. Yeah, I would say put the, like, a secondary damage of 2d6, but instead of damage, we both know it's healing.
Okay. Plus. Just give me a minute.
Meanwhile, Margaret is sort of just, like, going through her things. Sort of, like, making sure she's ready.
Yeah. Kaylin in the dark. Oh, not dark. Sorry. It's not dark in here. Kaylin continues reading her book.
Aww.
Which is Stella Luna. Which makes sense because she's underneath a bench of ants.
Yo!
Oh.
You fucking hit! And I realize that's actually probably really fucking bad.
It's not good.
It's not great.
Well, a zero is a 10, isn't it? Or what's the dice on that?
I put a 2d6.
That's weird.
That is weird.
What's happening here?
It's the crit. The plus is the crit.
So
actually, 2 and a 1.
Oh.
What the? That's fine.
Well,
what?
You still shouldn't have gotten.
But there's still a 0.
Yeah, zeros do not apply. Zeros don't apply here. Excuse me. How?
Well, fuck it. You stab her and heal her. We'll fix it later.
I don't know. I did my best.
I have a question, though. Can we, like, take a bathroom break here in just a sec?
Yeah, we can take it now. I mean, you're all having a break in game.
Yeah.
Yeah. I stab her.
Okay.
And frown at the dagger.
Why?
I mean, can I tell it didn't heal real good?
I mean, did it? This is crazy rolls.
It's some weird ass bullshit.
I'm going to look at this fucking thing that you put in.
I don't know how to put it. You put it on the weapons
one. No, it's right. I'm looking at it. It's okay.
Shh. Fix it, Delta.
Delta, please. Something dropped or someone farted really loud.
Something fell.
I have a cat on my lap and he won't freaking leave me. And I try to move him away and he won't.
Shy, shy. I love you.
Did you fix that?
It's the most pitiful of cats.
I love my small boy, but he won't fucking do
That's
shit.
That's much better.
Okay. Yeah. That's how that works. Okay.
There. Yeah. It was adding, like, strength or something?
Oh, yeah, it shouldn't do that.
Ah.
I don't know why it did that 0 or anything, though. That's fucking nuts, but yeah, I took away the strength and it fixed it.
It defaults the crit to, instead of doubling it, it does the whole add another dice roll.
Well, yeah, but it shouldn't have not gotten a 0.
Yeah, the crit should not have, unless, well... Oh, no, I think I might see. Well, no. Fuck it. We got it.
It's good. It's fine now. I stabbed her.
Professor's been stabbed.
Healer. She's a maze.
You can't use it again.
I have... It's 4 times a day.
Oh, 4 times a day?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I have 3 uses, though. It doesn't matter. Reverence looks so fucking happy.
Well...
Staring at her dagger in amazement.
Greta is also pretty amazed and, like, sort of looks and is, like, smiling. And he goes, "Whoever made you that blade is very well. That's amazing. I need this in my life."
There's a little
bit and says, "It's mine."
What was the guy's name?
No, but it's mine. You can't have it.
It's yours. I want to talk with this creator.
Oh,
go.
His name is Zabello.
So particularly charming Marcia. Fellow.
He is
in
very charming. He makes a lot of cool things.
This he gave
is
me his boots.
Pen holds up their leg.
That's right. Those boots.
There's his helmet.
But he sticks it
on your head. Explodes.
Reverence. I'm not sure. All right. Reference, I believe there was a no talking about that one.
Yeah.
A helmet that explodes heads.
No! No.
Don't look at me!
My boots are really cool.
It's really technical. Boots aren't really cool.
Out no far.
I also merit sort of points as here. I also have an earring from Zendello, which allows me to understand any spoken language. For a short amount of time, but...
Interesting. I must talk to this man. I will have to do that. She, like, pulls out, like, a notebook and writes down...
His job is in Marncha.
That's fine. I don't have any fucking city right now. I mean, you're there, and, like... To be honest, most of us, we do not leave very often, and it's very, by the book.
Let's collect our people at Marnshaw. Let's collect everyone and put them in Marnshaw.
Yes, because that'll totally be fine. It'll be fine. It's that's a totally low-polar Mercer. Even though he's already given us two fucking dragons. Anyway.
It's in the name. I say that every time.
Dungeons and Dragons.
Not enough dungeons.
I mean, we're in one right now, kind of.
No, we're in a cave.
It can be considered a dungeon to game.
It cannot.
It can be.
Dungeon world rules. The world is a dungeon.
I object.
Oh, we're playing Ace Attorney now, I see.
Yes.
You don't get to object. I'm the dungeon master.
I object.
There's no dungeons for you to be the master of.
The world's my dungeon.
Fuck you.
Anyway.
Chance.
Is Chance back?
He's making some noises. What noises?
Just dogs multiplying. Shut up. Fuck.
I'm back.
He's back.
Her mastiffs just multiply. And then
I realize
we ended up
talking a lot. I should get a drink. Fuck. I should have done that while chatting.
We'll do it now.
Go get a drink.
Go.
Go.
Slips into the Greta accent. Go do it now.
Good one.
I love the accent.
It's a good accent.
Eating himself, I'm just like, get fucking off my lap if you're gonna do that. Get off me. I know you ripped your throat.
He just wants to be near you.
Huh?
He just wants to be near you. He loves you.
Yeah, but he's being extra clingy this past week.
He loves you.
I know he loves me. I've had him since I was like 13. So... I think I got him when I was 13. I don't know. Okay, I need to put this collar back on you. So you can get rid of the fleas. God damn it. So how's everybody's day?
Pretty rad.
Played a lot of Pokemon.
I played Overwatch on someone else's stream and it was great.
My day's really good right now, but it's gonna be significantly better.
You leaned up far away.
Sorry.
Get up in the mic.
So my day's pretty good right now, but it's gonna drop significantly if I don't get my fucking letter.
Leaning straight like sideways, like into the mic.
You can take a picture of me.
Oh, yeah.
I'm gonna be upset if I don't get the letter.
I don't know if you're gonna get a letter dinner. In a cave.
There's actually... I saw, like, I was watching another D&D campaign, since I watched, like, 5 or 6. That's not including this one.
Living this one.
Yeah. There's one person who, like, had a, their character had a significant other. And in order to get mail, they did the whole, they both had a piece of paper that if they write on it, only the other person can see it. And if someone looks over the shoulder, no one can actually see what it says.
Thanks.
Oh, hey. App change.
You...
Yes.
Okay. You kind of tumblered. It's all blank still.
Yeah, well... Never mind.
I saw that it was... It's still blank, but it's there, and it had your name. So I assumed you at least started one to follow people, but then you haven't actually like delved into the monstrosity that is bad.
Maybe keep it that way.
Save yourself.
Totally you should look at all of the art that I reblog for Overwatch. It's so gay in there. There is so much McTitty in there.
Oh shit, City. Hello. Yeah.
I gotta zoom in because I don't like pixelated faces.
Meanwhile, I'm always zoomed out because I'm like, I gotta see this whole map. Just make sure I see all. Yeah.
I love just imagine... dragons.
Yeah.
Folk.
Hello from...
Dragon folk.
Look at these Argonians. Where's the Khajiit?
These Skyrim players.
I wish I was a Khajiit. I changed my mind. I want Caitlyn to be a Khajiit.
Look at these scalies.
She would be.
Look at these fucking furries. Look at that one's a child.
No.
I love him.
I love him.
I want to give their snoots a kiss. I want to kiss all the snoots. And that's not Caitlyn, that's me.
Thank you, Mom.
I'm gonna kiss all the snoots.
So, I assume this means we made it out alive. Maybe.
No, I was just, I was just opening up the map so you could see the faces again.
Okay.
Because so, I can see the faces, and I was like, maybe they wanted to.
I like the faces.
Yeah.
I like
powerful
seeing
eyebrows. Eyebrows, quotation marks, because they're scales.
Yeah,
but...
they are very powerful. Very Caitlyn, impressive.
Caitlyn also has powerful eyebrows.
She does.
But Greta could maybe kill someone with her eyebrows.
She, <Yeah. laughs>
she could, and I love it.
Greta,
I just stabbed her. And she loved it.
Yeah,
I can't wait for her and Zendila to fucking plot. Can you imagine?
All the good shit. Good shit.
Greta says...
We've set up a beautiful disaster. Anyway.
Greta says, we don't really leave the city too often, and most of the magic that is taught there is by the book, so there's nothing this fun. Or creative, and she like rolls her eyes. Haven't really practiced this kind of magic in a while.
Oh no, I just gotta tell you guys something.
Huh?
My cat.
Oh no.
He has a little tongue stick out problem.
Flap!
He's flapping! And if I try to get a photo of him, he'll not blep anymore.
Schrodinger's blab. Private. All right. Oh.
He fixed his blab. I'm sorry, continue. You guys can't.
It was important.
Yeah.
In improvisation of enchantments, yeah.
Well, well, I suppose it works. It is a little bit amateur. I mean, getting this sort of thing to work is always the fun part. So I suppose we could say he's well trained.
I'm not as well versed in enchantments, so something as unorthodox as that is it's a feat to me, but I've
you do magic.
Some. I'm not very familiar with many many schools, but I do.
I'm sorry.
Have some
I feel
magic.
Like there's something like flashing all over my. Do you see something on my face? No, I'm good. Yes, some bat poo.
You're fine.
I'm sorry for interrupt. Continue.
Caitlin had a laser point.
Fancy laser point.
I know some level of magics, but yeah. I've never been to the proper magical colleges and so on. My magic has been passed down.
I think I failed my gen magics test. Caitlin says suddenly from the silence.
It is not unusual for magic to be passed down. Most students have some sort of magic in their blood. On occasion, we get special cases like Aveco here who do not, and we teach them still. I'm sure anyone could do magic, and she looks at you, Caitlin.
Caitlin frowns.
I believe...
What?
Nothing. He just looks at the ground.
Granted, I have full trust. She's absolutely capable with her these particular daggers and the giant axe. So,
you have not seen me fight yet, though.
No, but I have full trust that you can.
I mean, you're carrying that thing. I mean, holy shit.
Yes, exactly.
She grins.
I have some daggers and a bow. I could not probably lift that thing, so you have my full respect.
Do you want to try?
No, not really.
Okay.
Can I try?
Oh my god, yes!
Pin?
Oh my god, yes. Okay. And I try to, like, I bring my axe over. I try and to Pen's open arms.
Gnomes have disadvantage with large weapons.
Oh hell yeah! Yep. Oh hell yeah!
And so just do a disadvantage strength check.
I'm so excited.
I was going to say Pen is actually stronger than Merit, but Merit's taller.
Yeah.
Oh!
Pen immediately falls over.
But I didn't drop it fully on Pen.
I mean, too late. The decision has been made.
What I was doing, I couldn't explain with words what I was doing with my hands. Like, you could see it. But I was basically lowering it down. And you know, when you teach someone how to swim, you basically half hold them.
You were half holding the axe while Pen
passed it. The more weight you give to Pen, the more Pen goes, oh!
I pick the axe back out and Pendar.
Pen still falls over.
I help Pen up.
Reverence looks very worried.
Anyways.
I love you, Ken. I'm so sorry.
Anyway, don't talk
about this. I'm sorry, I'm so strong.
This never happened.
Just so angry.
Ken suddenly angry is terrifying.
Anyways.
It's a 4 and a 1, my dude. Good God. Okay.
It's a bad roll.
Bad rolls.
Pen's gonna fall over no matter what. They got a 1.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, I was just looking at both of them. They rolled a 4 plus a 1, and then a 1 plus a 1. Oh God. Bless them.
Margaret pulls something out of her bag. Sort of like looks at it surprised for a moment. And then just looks at Reverence.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
I love her.
Oh my God.
She sort of, she gets up and, like, hands it to you and says, I believe this is for you.
Reverence looks kind of confused and takes it.
It's a letter.
Ah! Oh.
Who's ready to die?
Ah!
Siren,
thank you.
You have to read it to us.
I won't.
You have
look,
to.
No, you
I will
don't.
Read
the
it in his voice.
Characters don't need to know.
Fuck. Okay. Fucking.
I need to know.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Okay. Fuck.
Even if you just send it straight.
Just let me read it first.
Okay. We'll let you have this.
Okay.
This is a long letter. This is gonna take a while.
You guys have to read this. I have to read this.
Kaylin just looks over the shoulder and just goes, what the fuck are these pickles? And just walks away.
They are squiggles. It is not in common.
I was assuming that it wasn't in common.
Mare saw the exchange and sort of squinted, and a smile started creeping up, like, okay. Yeah, I see what's going on here.
Pen is sulking because of the axe incident.
I'm showing how close Pen was to Merit, because Merit might, like, pat them.
All I can think of for some fucking reason is that one video of the two people being called into the office of this guy, and he just turns the picture of his daughter around.
Oh! Yeah, I know what you're talking about. Oh, God.
I'm being begged for a reason.
Yeah.
I don't want to actually say what was said.
Yeah, I know. I can see it. It was from one of those remake movies. Anyway.
Mm-hmm.
Caitlin gives Merit that look and he just keeps smiling. He goes, I can tell you the whole thing a bit later. Which,
please do. Please do. I like gossip.
Oh, God!
Oh, no! Oh, no!
Delta, I think you're killing Siren.
Maybe.
I think Siren's dead. I can't believe that Siren's dead.
Chance can
can't
confirm.
Die yet.
He's just, like, staring at me this whole time!
Do we have a live witness? Can we...
Can we get a live witness?
Now with Chance, live on the scene.
Is she turning red?
Is she dead?
Little.
Yeah!
You can tell she's slightly dying inside.
Only slightly.
Nah, I'm more than that.
It's not, like, it's, I'm, listen, I'm
Tabby, I got a letter, okay?
Through tears.
Got a letter. I'm so happy.
Wink.
I'm so happy. Remember just smiling like a doof reading the letter. She looks like a dog. Yeah, I see this wink wonk. It's not a sexy letter.
Still. It's all of us just waiting to hear.
I mean,
we don't even know what the first letter was about, so, you know.
You have to read it, because there's, like...
Too much.
It's good.
You want me to read it?
Yes.
Fucking voiceover?
Yeah.
Please,
yeah.
Please. Oh god, oh god.
Let me summon Rizlan! No,
actually, Rizlan.
Do not
please.
Troll. Do not troll, I swear okay. to fuck. I will punch you.
So, a white envelope with a red wax seal. Although the envelope itself is well kept, the paper within has been clearly crumpled before and then attempted to smooth out again. The lettering is mostly clean, but gets messy towards the end as well. There are several mistakes that have been scratched out. It vaguely smells. Darling Reverence. In truth... Oh, God, fuck. I've immediately lost my place. Okay, hold on. In truth, common is easier for myself, but this will do. Language as a whole is a nuisance, but necessary occasionally. I'm sorry we missed each other. That is crossed out. Spelled wrong. I, too, was going to look for you, but before I departed, but didn't get a chance. You were going in the morning, and by the afternoon you'd set out. I'm not entirely sure when you will get this letter. Messages take a long time to work their way to me when I am working. If ever. In truth, most of the time I'm required to be cut off from others. Regardless, this should reach you much faster than it took to get to my hands. Probably. No promises. It depends on a certain someone noticing. Don't worry, she won't tamper with it. Margaret is better than that. This knife of yours sounds delightful. Where in the world did you buy it? I'm fairly certain that is no enchantment. Also, I'm not sure if you noticed, but I am a fan of Scar. I'm sure yours is lovely. I'm not sure if I've met these people. I'm assuming they're guild members since they're accompanying you, but I remember faces better than names, unfortunately, as well as I have this bad habit of hiding away in my room for the entirety of my downtime and leaving for months. Really, the only ones I know extensively well are those who have been there for as long as I have, which continually becomes less and less. Thank you for writing to me. It was surprising. I rarely receive mail, even rarer when it's an actual letter rather than news. Since the nature of my work often requires me to work up, and I tend to become very withdrawn and cut off. Up my own ass, if you will. But it's all right. I enjoy solitude for the most part. Again, I must apologize for the time it takes for word to get to me. As it is currently, I'm close to my objective, and the channels to me will go dead in order to keep whatever semblance of cover I have. Realistically, we may not be able to speak again until we both return to the guild hall. I'd love to tell you about it, however, having it written down, even on something as simple as this, could potentially risk my head. So I will not be disclosing those details. I like having my head. Anyway, I'm about to the end of the little time I have to go. I'm in a closet right now, and not convenient, not great, pretty cramped and dark. Oh, yep, there's gotta go fondly. R.
Fondly.
That was gay.
And the ship sails. I can see it in the distance. It has a beautiful flag.
Last time. Song is old as rhyme. That was great. Thank you.
So excited. Just fucking clapping.
Let me give you snaps. I can't snap very well.
Only one of my hands can snap. I can't. My right hand, even though I'm dominantly right-handed, it doesn't snap. Anyway.
Quick merit, kiss Noah.
No. What I'm dreaming for Noah Merritt.
No.
Noah Merritt. You guys gotta share that fucking tea.
With the one tea packet of that he has left, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, because Leandra wanted that tea.
Yeah. Also, my favorite thing here is that we all switch to add a character, and then we have Noah.
Yeah, I...
No, it's fine. I feel like we get it.
Noah in real life.
It just cracks me up.
Noah in real fantasy life.
I mean, if he sees the smugness that is Merritt and Reverence smiling over a letter, he might could be like, what's going on here? And, you know, like, yeah.
Uh-huh.
Let me just put emphasis again. She looks really doofy. Like, you know how when people smile at their text messages and someone's like, oh, who you texted? Is that your boyfriend?
She looks I'm sorry, like but Merritt's about to be... Merritt's about to be that guy. I'm sorry, but I'm not. He's still smiling each time, and he goes, a wondrous letter you have there?
She rolls it up. She looks at him and folds it up and puts it back in its thing and tucks it away. Yes. Oh. It was yeah.
Oh, Reverence, that reminds me of that letter you were writing earlier. You have to teach me Infernal sometime. It looks like a fascinating language.
Nope.
Seeing as it sat trying to read the letter, Seeing as it seems like you tried to read the letter as I was writing it, yeah. I don't think I will.
And sulks more. They're not having a good hour.
Margaret leans in Pen and goes, I can teach you.
Pen's eyes light up.
Maybe don't, Margaret.
You don't hear anything. Just kidding.
I have eyes.
I would assume she'd cover her mouth.
Yeah. I mean, I did in real life.
Yeah, but like, Reverence knows.
That's fair.
It's Dwayne a Pin. Pin, you now have the calming Barack Dwayne.
Excellent. Thank you, Kaylin.
Did you just say Barack?
No.
Like, I think you did.
Like Barack Obama?
No. I said the calming Rock Dwayne.
Dwayne the Rock Johnson.
So anyway, that was a fun little reprieve.
That was
it was very fun.
Yeah.
That was gay.
It was too straight.
It was a little too straight.
It was very dang. Heterosexual.
Very heterosexual.
And that's why you chimed in with
Man, I don't know what it was about that Rizlon voice, but it dried my throat the fuck out.
The drink.
I'm fucking desert. Hold on, you're hit the cough drop and see if I can still fucking do.
Hey, can you give me the pitcher of water?
No.
Drink the whole pitcher. Chug.
Everyone is fucking thirsty.
Dang, all you're so thirsty.
I was just about to say it.
I'm thirsty!
We know you are.
I mean, meanwhile, I just opened up a new bottle of water. because I had finished off the one I had sitting in my room.
You guys are terrible.
Speaking of thirst, I love Greta's eyebrows.
You're welcome. Yeah. You're welcome for that.
It fits so well.
She's actually constantly making a face, but you can't tell it's all scales.
Sort of like when Reverence rolls her eyes, but you can't tell.
Yeah, it's really unfortunate that you can't tell, because it's very frequently.
I love that so much, though. Like,
you guys have been together for more than a month, so you guys could be able to tell the tells of an eye roll from Reverence.
I mean, I feel like it's pretty obvious, even if you can't see the eye roll. You can just see all the other subtleties, like shoulders drooping, or like the way like maybe her eyelids move, as opposed to just seeing the irises move, because you can't.
Because you can't.
You've picked up on the subtleties of...
Yes.
You know, when she's flicking her tail, she's angry like a cat.
Like, that's true, though.
I know.
It's, like, completely accurate.
When her ears go back.
No, that doesn't happen.
Kaylin has long ears. Kaylin has long ears. I totally forgot.
I don't think people can control their ears like that.
Hmm? It depends on what sort of headcanon we want to do about elves. Because there is headcanon that
really
elves...
I like the ear moving for elves.
Yeah.
Yeah. It is headcanon. Like, here and there, folks have headcanons that elves have ears that are sort of like cats. I mean, not, you know, set up real high, but they can move in the same sort of range.
Delta, you're the only one that can call this.
Don't you remember when elves descended from the Feywild because they were cats?
Yes!
Elves are the original Khajiits. We should probably...
What you're telling me is...
Probably play Dungeons and Dragons.
Everyone in this campaign's a furry.
Yeah.
Bad.
Would you look at that? We're all furries. This whole time. Anyway, now that we've all faced this violent truth.
I mean, I should just accept it solemnly. I have Sonic the Hedgehog comics from childhood. Anyway.
You added yourself like this.
Yeah, because I was like, okay, I can get out of this scot-free, because Merritt technically is not. But
no,
fucking, I can't lie.
He fucking talks to furries.
Yes.
Yeah.
And he talks to animals. In animal.
He's like at least three quarters furry.
He doesn't have the visuals, but he has everything else.
He has the brain of a furry.
Okay.
Anyway.
D&D.
No, he's a plant. Remember, he's a plant. He's not a furry, he's a plant. And then we have Scaly.
He's leafy?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, his father was. That's how this whole mess happened.
Oh.
Oh, God.
Jesus.
Shut up.
I want to die.
Shut down our whole campaign.
Okay, listen. Let's go.
I don't want to listen when you just said those words.
No, let's go. D&D, paint pictures. Paint word pictures.
Please. Please, for the love of...
Yes, just go ahead and kill me. Let's go.
For the love of Melora. I swear to fuck.
Pen, did you spend a spell?
No.
It doesn't come back yet, does it? No.
It was a ritual.
Yeah. I thought someone did. Doesn't matter. Oh, his cough drop is bad. So yeah, you rest for a good 30-40 minutes, depending on how long you wanted to talk to those bats. You all get the short rest, though. Get up. You're all ready to go. Continue into the cave. There are three
splits in the path, which way would you like to?
The eternal D&D question. Which way, motherfuckers?
Okay, silly question. Why are we down here again?
We are investigating whatever the fuck made the earthquakes. They were digging through trying to find what could have been causing them so far. And now we're looking in the places they have not explored yet, because, you know, shit broke.
Got it.
I'm pretty sure that's it.
That sounds right.
Do you want to turn around?
No.
No.
That was out of character, but okay.
This is clarification for Benji.
Benji,
listen,
forgets things.
Benji, your voice is the same as Penn's.
It is. It really is. I'm so sorry.
Make a character, but no. I'm joking.
I can't make a Kaylin character voice because her voice is actually deeper than mine, and I can't go deeper with my voices. I only can go higher.
Meritz is. I've said this before. Meritz is just inherently different to mine, and I can't make up the difference, except doing a slightly lower, proper, weird sound. Who the fuck knows?
Fuck it. Go through the center one.
Meritz turns to Greta and says, "So which way?"
Do we go?
Eeny, miny, moe. Greta takes the torch, sort of like holds it out into each of the hallways and like looks carefully down them.
I don't even know how to spell eeny. I tried to freaking type Kaylin was gonna play eeny, miny, miny, moe with a ad.
Oh god.
Before sort of like shrugging and turning back to like all of you, and then sort of like gestures to Margaret and says, "You're good at this sort of thing, right? But where are we go? Which way should we go?" And Margaret sort of like, "This is not my specialty."
Just go through the center one. I'm going through the center one. I'm walking.
I guess we'll go through the center one. And she's just following you.
I mean, you always go left, but sometimes that's a trap. And so you go right, but sometimes
that's a trap.
Yes. But still.
Noah, you are also a ranger.
Wait, what?
You are also a ranger, oh. Are you?
Yes.
Can you... Which way do we go?
Can you range this?
Can you range this?
I mean...
I don't think he can, like, track an earthquake.
I don't think I can track this.
Delta, can he range this?
But something is telling me left.
The most he could discern is, like...
Can I do a nature check to see which cave looks more shaky?
Caleb's
We've
gone.
Already fucking I mean, lost yeah. Caleb. God damn it. Merrick goes, grabs Kaylin, and like tries to drag her back.
I let it happen.
Okay. Bam!
Oh. Whoa!
So which cave is more shaky, Delta?
You go in each cave and inspect them all, and like touch the ground and like sniff the dirt.
Put your ear to the ground. Just tell me what the stone tells me you're a little bitch.
Hey, this cave says you're all little bitches. You can tell the one on the far left seems to just sort of end. The one on the middle continues into a further cave system. And the one on the right does as well, but you can hear water in that one.
Water's like promising.
You can hear moving water.
From my nature senses, it seems like there's running water down the far right cave. That could be promising. A breach in the wall, at least, that we could look at.
Patch. Well.
P- Pen marches off in that direction.
I trust your nature senses. Reverence follows Pen.
Merit follows Reverence.
I guess I'm going this way now.
Yeah, I have not. I'm still.
She lets it happen, by the way, because she doesn't like when someone tries to drag her away. She actually lets it happen if they slightly know her.
That's adorable. She's
successes.
Yeah. So if Penn tried to do it, it would happen.
Just reach up and grab. All right.
It's happened with a small child before.
They all shrug and follow you. You enter the cave. There are significantly more stalactites and mites in this section. Like, you can tell immediately water runs through this place. You start, you head down for a while, and then you reach this river, like an underground river that is rushing by, and it is a lot of water moving, and it's going down. And there are essentially the path that you took enters into like a long, it's a narrower cave, but there is water running down it, and it goes in two directions.
We're going to get lost in here.
I can't happen to retcon a thing because Merit would do it, even though I forgot to as we left. Can I?
What is it?
Merit probably would have left a flower or some sort of mark of like, this is where we were, and then carried on through the cavern to where we've...
Don't you have an innate sense of geography and maps?
I mean, we both do, but like, this is wonder. Geography can always recall the general layout of terrain. This is true? My thing is, first off, Merit, like...
Face it?
Yeah. Second off, Merit doesn't really do caves. Mm. So, like, it's a little wonky for him. So he would go ahead and leave a trail as if this is some fey shit going on, but it's basically his own sense of it's his way of feeling a bit better about possibly being lost in this cave. Because, like, I had thought about it as we were choosing the caves, but then I forgot to say anything. As we actually chose.
I'll say you leave a flower at the split in the three. I don't think you would have thought about it before. Just because, like, it was a pretty singular path, and also, like,
yeah, that's why I'm
kind of distracted.
Just as something as like, we've already been here. Just like, even if he takes a flower from his plethora of them in his hat.
I'll say you leave a mark at the beginning of where it splits.
Yeah.
And you can do that from now on, if you say it. If you don't, then there's no retconning it.
Yes. Thank you. It's something Merit would definitely be doing, because he's concerned about how far this actually goes.
So, now, just to be clear, the water in this room, is it an underground river, or is it rushing in, like, from earthquake stuff? Can we tell?
No, you can't tell.
Okay, just lots of water.
There's a lot of water moving very quickly. Like, from your immediate, like, view, you can't see sort of, like, grooves in the walls that would imply that this entire, like, cavern thing where the water is rushing through was carved by the water. You don't know?
Okay. Boy, that sure is a lot of water.
Hmm.
Do we want to go into the water?
Maybe we should test how fast it's running, see if it's going to drag us under.
I lost where it was, and I had to search for it, so that's going to be in the recording.
Reverence wrinkles her nose and says, I don't particularly want.
I wish I had a Ziploc bag from Celaluna.
Fantasy Ziploc.
We can head back and try the other way.
Pen is going to stick their quarter the end of the quarterstaff in the water to see how hard it's like. Go.
No.
Make a strength check.
Okay. Reference grabs Pen's arm as...
I mean, they're not leaning over. This is if...
But still, like... They're small.
Pen is a weak little gnome.
Oh, good. I was so worried I was going to lose my quarterstaff.
I was you hold thinking... on, a lot of water splat. Like, this is very fast water.
Mm-hmm. It seems like a poor decision to go into that water.
Yeah, I was thinking not. Not a good decision.
Let's turn back then, shall we?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Perhaps there will be another way.
Can I just check and see if there's anything else interesting in the room other than lots of water?
What are you looking for?
Anything more out of the ordinary?
Like, yeah, any sort of disturbances in the room like that could have been caused by the earthquake or quakes or things like that. Not like animals or anything, but, you know. Nature-y, I guess.
Make a perception check.
Sweet.
Or no, make an investigation check.
Okay. Are you
well,
sure?
Well, I mean, you already...
I mean,
I can roll an investigation.
What is your investigative modifier?
It's 2. So
21. So yeah, that's still high.
Yeah. It's a fucking 19, my dude. Anyway.
There are, again, loose rocks. There are, like, more here. And you get the feeling it's because you are, you know, closer to where it has happened and deeper underground, which would be affected more. You don't necessarily see cracks. There are a few broken stalactites.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. Yeah, this cave is boring. Let's go back.
All right.
Okay, I solved this nature mystery.
Yeah.
Okay.
We go back and try the other path, I guess.
The middle path also seemed to go on for a while, says Pen.
I was correct.
What did the left one right. have? Did it end?
Yeah, whatever? The first one ends after a little while. I mean, we can check that since it's a pretty short one.
As we get back to the three-way split thing, Merit, like, moves the flower and places it specifically in front of... If he hasn't already, he specifically places it in front of the right side that we just went through. Just like, okay, we've been here.
Perhaps just to be thorough, we check the shortest path.
Okay.
I'm agreeing with reverence.
And then go through the middle.
Okay.
May as well.
Way to go.
We do that.
We do that!
Do that there thing.
We do the thing.
So you start going down the leftmost path, and like, very quickly you start seeing things are more damaged down this cave, and like, there's not cracks again, but like, there is more broken rock. You know, there are pieces that have fallen from the ceiling. And, you know, after about 10 minutes, the entire cave has caved in.
Hmm.
Well, either this one solved itself, or this could have led to the worst of the earthquake, maybe?
Can you see through the cave in at all, or is it just a bunch of rocks and dirt and stuff?
I mean, if we're underground, or if we're underwater, and it's... I feel like it would be, like, straight up caved in.
I mean...
Yeah, probably, it is a solid wall of...
Yeah, because we got okay. Water pressure breaking that down. It ain't going nowhere.
Man, I sure wish I had prepared melt into stone.
Who?
I'm not sure that would be a good idea, honestly.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If I may not remember
go
that.
Go back to the middle path.
Oh, never mind. Splicking. You can't move with my...
Yeah. You can be a part of the beginning, but you can't just slide through.
You can become a permanent fixture.
Middle path, go.
So
do that.
As you enter back into this main room, you do actually feel the beginning of something rumbling through the earth.
Uh-oh.
And,
I'd just like to point out Merritt was probably holding the flower he was going to mark that trail off with. It begins shaking. He just drops it, like, oh. Just drops the flower. Looks all up, of, like, oh no.
All of the bats start, like, stirring, and are like, fuck. Fuck.
I just hear a bunch okay, of them fuck. Cursing.
And then, like, they start, like, moving, and then, like, they move as a, like, huge cloud of bats out yeah, the way you came in.
That's not a good sign.
And Greta turns to you and goes, okay, we need to move.
We need to leave.
Very quickly.
We need to leave right now.
Most plugging perhaps later. And Merritt just follows the bats. He wants out now.
Eric, Craig, come back.
I don't want any slugs, but please.
Just someone tell
let me come with you.
Hey, Delta. Mm-hmm. Is there a Bruce? Just in my fantasy.
Sure, yeah.
Yeah!
You needed Bruce. That Batman reference.
We won't make it out of the way we came in time. It was an hour's trip.
No, but we must find a more stable piece of the cavern.
It's more stable up. Kaylin does not want to be in here.
Yeah, that's so more stable above. Let's go.
I am running after Merritt. So I could probably run faster.
Merritt is probably looking for at least something much more stable than this immediate vicinity. If not, like, running straight out.
Yeah, let's do this.
You make it back a few caverns, caves, halls, whatever the fuck they are, kind of all three. And, you sort of realize, like, you're not gonna, like, it's not gonna get better the further you go in time to get out or to a safer place and sort of, like, find the safest place you can and bunker down. And, the rumbling sort of builds up again, and it starts just, everything is shaking, and it's kind of terrifying.
He turns and runs back to the group.
I want to protect as many people as I can with my body.
It's like, okay, I thought this might be good. This is not good. Friends!
This is bad.
He's gonna die. He doesn't want to die alone.
Yeah, you all sort of, like, hunker down and protect each other, like, hands on the back of your head, fucking fetal position, earthquake, school drill.
Yeah.
That most of us missed. Anyway.
You know what I'm talking about, though.
I do. Yeah, I mean,
that's all that matters.
I participated in several. I didn't leave till 6.
And you wait it out. It shakes for about 10 minutes. The cave you're in, for the most part, doesn't really seem super effective. Affected. A few, you know, loose rocks.
You've been playing too much Pokemon.
Super effective. A few loose rocks fall down. If you're a bird type, you're in trouble right now. Bird type?
No. Aren't they immune to ground?
You nearly have it.
Anyway.
A few loose rocks fall, and, you know, like, one of the stalactites falls, but, like, the roof doesn't cave in, and none of you are hurt. And, after a bit, the shaking stops again, and you're left in the room.
Well, that was spooky.
Well, that was fun, wasn't it?
Merritt looks... No pun intended. He does look shaken. He does not... Yeah, that was just the first word that came into mind. This is... He's not down for spelunking anymore.
This isn't fun anymore.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He does look a little perturbed. He's very aware of how closed in this space is now. Just
very
entirely.
Very claustrophobic.
Now that we've been, like, in the belly of an earthquake, if that's a thing, is there a way that we can tell if this is natural or not? Does it feel weird? Is it a magical earthquake?
I mean, the earth was sort of just shaking. Like,
okay.
There's, like, I could make you roll, but I don't think I can justify anything that you come up with.
Fair enough.
It was an earthquake. Nothing weird about it,
just...
Like, there wasn't any sort of, like, oh shit, what was that sound? Like, it was an earthquake. You sort of... You could hear things falling occasionally.
I kind of want to ask if there was some sort of, like, pattern to the way it was an earthquake, but I don't... I personally have never experienced an earthquake, so I don't know if there is, like, some sort of pattern to the...
Californians.
Yeah.
What's an earthquake?
No.
I know what a tornado is.
There was not a pattern.
Yep.
No, it wasn't specific. Fucking vibrating a heartbeat.
Boom, boom. No. No. It was just shaking.
It was an earthquake. Cool. Let's go down the center cave.
Turn to Greta. Two in as many days? Didn't you say they were like a week apart before?
Yes, this is not normal. I fear if this is not looked into, it will begin to consume the lake. We should look. At least to see if this is caved in.
Reverend starts going to the middle.
As does Ben.
We have to go down there again.
It sort of takes a moment and then gets up and goes with the rest of the party.
Yeah.
You
know what kind of looks at the right cave, but he just kind of goes...
Okay.
I really want to solve your water puzzle.
Yeah, I want to solve the water puzzle, but...
But I can't go down there alone, so, like,
let's die from the water.
You could probably ask someone to go with you, but... it's not a great idea.
Still not a great idea. Best to have the full party. Have all the friends.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's kill all everybody in the water puzzle.
I mean, at least...
We're gonna die, we gotta do it all together, guys.
It's
gotta be a TPK.
TPK or go home.
Middle path.
My legs are seriously gonna fall asleep soon.
So you start heading down this middle path. It still looks secure for the most part. There's no caved in that you can immediately tell. This pathway is wider than the ones that you came down, thankfully. Especially considering now you're all kind of feeling claustrophobic.
get the brown bags. Breathe slowly.
Do not hyperventilate.
Don't hyperventilate.
Reverence is used to small spaces.
I'm so sad.
But is she used to small spaces that could maybe...
That shake? Her? No.
Yeah.
She's not feeling great, but, like, the fact that the cave isn't...
So Reverend hasn't been to the shaking box?
No, she has not been,
naughty.
Like, to the shaking box for naughty children.
Yeah.
Would be used to, like, caves and stuff, but, like, not shaking.
Merritt's got a weird thing, too much space is too much. Like, in a just a wide open desert or just open sea, he would probably not feel really, really good. Down here in this little claustrophobic cave, he's not feeling good either. He's just screwed. Just put this tiny tree back in a forest. That's what I'm getting at. Please save him.
Please. So you head down this pathway for quite a while, like a good 15 minutes or so. And then you see the slug. It's...
A slug?
The slug?
The slug?
The slug?
It's gonna be a very large slug.
It's it's not super... Like, it's maybe the size of a dog.
It's a big slug. It's a slug!
Slug, man.
Does it have a face?
Seeing the slug, Merrick goes, Oh. What? Now he's
so
just thinking about these.
Talking about.
Yeah, because he's like
these normal sized bats.
Yeah, now he's scared of the bats because he's just thinking about them swarming this monstrosity. And now he's no more freaked out for different reasons.
My brain, for my sake, does it have a face?
No.
Or does it just have a slug face?
Slug.
It's just
It's surprising at first. It sort of has this bioluminescence to it that's sort of like vaguely illuminates it. It's a dull blue. It's big, which is the immediate reaction. It seems kind of like lost at where it is, just like that. That snail, like, feeling around sort of thing. And it, you sort of, like, look around, and there is, like, a few, like, tunnels in the wall that this snail has possibly come out of. Snail? Slug? But yeah, it doesn't seem, like, aggressive or anything. Just large and surprised.
Hey, same, dude.
A slug is just a snail without a home.
Yeah.
Poor thing. We just give the slug a wide berth, I assume.
I just want to walk away around it. I do not want to go near it.
Puffing or looking
Noah
at
pokes
the
slug.
It sort of like looks at you. But then it like kind of curiously is like slithering over, but it's again not aggressive, it's just a slug.
I kind of want to give it bacon. You're nasty.
Even though his hand's all slimy, he's like, already this far. He's pets the slug.
It's slimy. It is.
Yeah.
It is that.
Merritt looks over to Pin and goes, so when the bats mentioned slugs, did you recall me mentioning that? They were here for very... big slugs for food?
You did say they were worried about us stealing their food.
I don't think they have to worry about that. If they are talking about slugs like that.
I'm not eating that.
I am not either.
That thing's larger than I am.
It's like the same size.
It could possibly eat you. Please don't go near it.
Please don't go near it.
I want to pick up Pen and protection. Do not go near the slug.
You just hear, please don't get near the slug, and you just pick up Pen like, I got you.
Can somebody nature-y do a nature check to see if it's wide? And can somebody also do an arcana check? I'll do that one.
I mean, it's a really big slug. I'm not certain that it's, like, supernatural. Or, you know what I mean. It's not mega natural. It might be supernatural.
I'm
it's a dire slug. What are you talking about?
A dire slug.
Dire slug.
Oh, shit. Okay.
So what's up with that slug? Is it magic?
I was going to say Merritt might do an arcana, but fucking Reverence has got it.
Fucking weird slug. Look at this weird dog.
I'm gonna say this is more nature.
Okay.
Just I meant to say nature instead of
survival. Oh god!
Idea. That's a fucking slug.
It's really big.
That's a fucking slug!
That's a fucking slug!
Just subtract one from my...
20.
I got a 15 out of 16.
Stops petting the slug, he just kind of pats it on the, like,
head, I guess. What, front what part of it
connotates the head? Yeah.
Like
the head zone.
And then he kind of walks off and kills everyone else.
You've seen slugs before, Noah. This is a weird slug.
No fucking way.
Like you could get the sense that like slugs could grow big on their own, you know, like left unpredated. Preyed upon. Unpredator. There it is.
There you go.
Unpreyed upon, and you know, with whatever food they want. This one's a little big.
A little too much.
There is some sort of enhancement happening to it, you think? You're not sure the source. But it's
my brain just has a thing.
It's not like magically enhanced, just like you give a goldfish the biggest tank and then it becomes the biggest goldfish.
I release the goldfish into the wild. Damn, it's a big goldfish.
So
there is
nobody thinks it's like a very large slug making the world shake, right?
I mean, the thought crossed my mind.
That wouldn't happen, right?
I mean, the tunnels are interesting.
It may not be the slug, it might be whatever's making slugs this fucking massive.
Pen's gonna
okay.
stick
out. As like walks back, it's like getting the slime off of his hand. It off.
Get closer to your mic.
Okay.
You're cutting a little bit. Alright.
But yeah, he's just wiping off the slime and he kind of goes like, yeah, that's not natural. That's not a normal slug.
That's not normal.
Can you stuck your head in a hole, right?
Yeah.
Oh, God.
It's slimy.
Oh, God. Pin's hair.
Aww. Yeah, it's immediately in your hair.
Oh.
You have anime hair. Congrats.
The whole seems to go on for an indeterminate amount of time.
The star slug is fucking freaking me out.
It's a slimy slug hole.
Disgusting. Are all the other holes slimy slug holes too?
There's not a lot, but yeah.
Cool. Question.
Mm-hmm.
Do slugs normally eat whole stone?
I mean, this is sort of compact dirt and stone. Like it's a combination.
Slugs eat dirt wibbled.
You stuck your head in this hole, you got the idea that this slug did not eat through the wall. Like, maybe this was, like, a thinner piece of stone because the slugs, like, had eroded around it. And just because of the shaking, it had now crumbled out and produced a slug.
Okay.
Ew.
Let's keep going and not be here.
Let's get away from this slug. I don't like it.
Goodbye, slug.
Bye, slug, buddy.
The slug is already slugging away.
Talk to the slug.
No, seriously, Merritt, can you talk to the slug?
Maybe. I didn't want to try.
Merritt, I don't want to do this.
Just say, slug hey, yo, friend. Slug boy.
Slug talk with Merritt.
Merritt tries? I don't know what noises slugs make, and I don't know if Merritt does either.
Please don't make these sounds.
Please, for both our sakes, because that's just, please. Oops,
those are the sounds for reference, but don't do it.
No!
Just like thinking about Merritt approaching, and he's just like slapping his cheeks, trying to make the right sounds.
He would be such a good voice actor in another life.
The perfect crow claw.
Damn you, Taliesin, for having the perfect crow claw.
Yeah, what you to be the voice for our entire, like, Disney movie of animals. Anyway, sorry.
Furries is the word.
Yes.
You approach the slug, Helen Mummet slug. The slug slowly turns to you. It is a slug. It's pretty slow and sort of like looks at you and goes, "Hello."
Thank you for using fake Rizlan voice.
Marisu turns back to the party and makes a grimace.
Reverence gives you two thumbs up and a really genuine smile.
Kaelin is not happy.
Pen is standing right next to
Reverence. So big, Merit!
Also thumbs up.
Merit takes a moment and just like rubs the bridge of his nose and then looks back to the slug and goes, "Hello, friends!"
Hello.
You wouldn't have happened upon anything particularly strange beyond caverns, would you? In your travel through the holes.
You can see the loading sign on that slug's face. And it sits
it's
there.
It's now doing a blue circle.
For like a good 30 seconds, and you're like looking around like,
Is this Utopia?
Actually.
And then honestly, Merit would still be looking at it, still trying to muster his faux like friendliness, because he doesn't want to be here, but he's gonna.
And then it sort of looks at you and says, "Strange how."
Well, kind of like the earthquake we just had.
There's been a lot of things that
has anything felt like as the earth. Let me figure out how to say this. Have the earthquakes ever felt any worse in your travels? Was there like a specific Slug travels?
Listen, man. They're the same thing. I mean, I just... So, yeah. They're not great right now.
Did you ask it why it's so big? Did you... What did it say?
Holds up one thing. How, pray tell, did you become this massive? Most slugs I have met are not so.
It's pretty weird, right?
It's a little. I'm a little weird too, though, so.
That's good. I don't know, I just getting bigger.
Right. Ask it if there's other big slugs.
Are there any other larger slugs that you know of?
They're all pretty big.
Oh, good. Things you miss because we're not on camera. I just looked up at my own ceiling like, God, why? I am
so much kind of small. Really good.
Right. I also just remembered, don't slugs and snails like eat leaves?
They do.
Do you think Merit has ever had that problem?
It's entirely possible.
Okay. Another mental note. Merit does not like
eats your hair. Stop literally talking to things. Your hair.
Probably why he's uncomfortable. He doesn't like slugs. It's not because they're slimy, it's because they're vicious.
Vicious.
Quotation marks. Right. Okay.
Merritt, give us the slug deets.
Merritt just turns. Merritt goes goodbye and turns on his heel and goes right back to the party. Have a nice day. Right, so the slug knows nothing. Next to nothing. Does not know how it got that large. Knows there are larger slugs. Will.
Remus looks pretty sad that the slug didn't give any good information.
I just sort of looks at Raven's face and goes, it's a slug. I mean, bless its heart, but it's a slug. What? Bless its heart is a thing that I've heard other people even say. What is it?
Don't ask me. I don't know.
She sort of shakes his head and goes,
I mean,
anyway.
I guess she does, because blessings.
Yeah.
Rest the slug? Do slugs have hearts?
I think
they have multiple.
What?
Yeah.
The only heart I know about is a fish heart, and that's because science.
Well, that sucks. Let's go.
Yes, please.
Remus turns around and keeps going, I guess.
Okay. Do you guys want to stop?
Yeah, I'm sleepy. Yeah.
We can stop here and pick it up.
2 or 3:47. We're in a cave. This is going to be forever.
There's slugs.
This is
bad. Big.
So many friends.
Slug eating bats. Fuck.
So not great. Less great the bats.
That I didn't take speak with animals.
And you had to rely on my terrible ass. I'm so sorry.
Slugs do not have hearts, actually.
Okay.
What am I thinking? Chance that has it. Multiple hearts. Maybe it's
they
worms.
They still have a circulatory
worms
system.
Worms have four hearts,
as
I think.
As opposed to a heart that does the same thing.
Cows have, like, four stomachs.
They got five.
Five?!
Too many stomachs.
At least three of them are just cheese.
That's a lot of fuck.
I gotta go, guys. Cause...
Good night.
Because you guys are very robot-y right now, so.
Oh, gosh.
Oh, sorry.
Night.
Love you.
Love you too. Now I gotta stop everything. Okay, bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.